Well, here we are, folks. Classified France. We're going to see how this goes. Check one more setting here. All right, we're going to start a new campaign. Let's give it a ride. Making sure I got on my Twitter, Twitch, all that jazz set up here. All right, let's go. New campaign. It's supposed to be like XCOM. Let's see what it's actually like. Choose difficulty. Regular. That works for me. Iron Man mode and tutorials. Okay. Yeah. Standard stuff. Campaign one. Let's go. YouTube stream. Classified France. Some weapons have a chance to apply status. Okay.
We are parachuting into France to make contact with the resistance. We're a three-man team with orders to set the country ablaze. I'll introduce you. Tom King, a strung-out Britisher who likes explosives a bit too much. Vincent, our scout, a quiet Canuck. And myself, Willard Cassidy, who runs this outfit on a captain's salary of 200 bucks a month. My heart belongs to the Lord, but I am going into the shadows to fight a godless foe. We drop. Things immediately go wrong. In high winds, we get separated, blown apart, well away from the drop zone. Tom and I land close together. No sign of our resistance contact, but the area's flush with krauts. After we ditch our chutes, Tom and I find a farmer's barn to hole up in and check our bearings.
It's kind of appropriate because my dad was just texting me last night about how he had just finished watching Band of Brothers again for like the second time. I think I've watched it three times in total. I love that series.
We should hold tight here till the heat's off.
The Fuhrer's okay. Flying monkeys have other plans.
Oh, so much for a warm welcome.
Mouse over the highlighted cell, then press to move Willard Cassidy. So just like XCOM, click to target. Okay.
Moving out.
All right, my friend. Switch to Tom by pressing the tab. His portrait will click him directly. Yes. Okay, go to yourself. Okay. The actions available to you are determined by your remaining action points. In this case, you want your team to hold their positions without using their remaining AP. Press the backspace or end turn at the top right to end your turn. All right, backspace is not very convenient, so click that.
Swell, a target.
Too bad we weren't on Overwatch here. Private, trained soldier, rifle effective at long range. Okay. Oh my god, there's a bunch of enemies there. Holy crap. Stealth attacks, weapon. Select your melee attack to show possible targets. Really? Okay, so. Press and highlight a cell to move and attack. Oh, that's not going to be very stealthy. Wait a minute, can I switch and do the other guy? Nope, I can't. So can I move over here and then attack? Click on the target cell to... Oh, this one he's saying. Okay. He wants me to go up there. I was like, I gotta kill this guy. I see. So if I go there, it will say... Oh, and I see. His arrow's pointing right there. Okay.
Hush now, Herman.
Oh. Well, that was nice. And all these guys are looking the other way. Each time you silently kill an enemy, the ambush meter increases. Oh, so they have an ambush meter. Fun. When the meter is filled, your team immediately launches an ambush and gains an extra turn. Oh, that's going to be a mechanic I like very much. Okay, so select your melee attack. Oh, and then you want me to go there? See, I would have gone right here next to the guy, but they want you to go from behind, don't they? That's how... Okay. All right, I'll see if I can... Unaware is what our scenario is up top. Stealth takedown. Okay. And these guys are just waiting because they're like, those guys in the barn are going to take care of it. We sent both of them in. Camera controls, Q and E to rotate. Use the scroll wheel to zoom. Yes. Oh, yes, XCOM. Oh, can I scroll? Can I? Wait a minute. Why is it so slow that way? Okay, you want me to go over there, though, and kill that guy. Okay.
Moving out.
Wow, that's a pretty aggressive move.
Hidey-ho, I got a target.
While in bushes, undetected allies are invisible. Select your melee attack. So, wait a minute. Click on the target cell to attack any of these. I'll be what? Seen there? And here are bushes. Hold on. Oops. Where does it want me to go? Here? Oh no, it says here? Oh. Okay. Click on the target cell to attack. Just him?
Chew on that.
Oh, he's in a bush.
What is this? He's taking a shine to you, Willard.
Some actions emit sound. Okay, this is cool because this also is a thing in Cyber Knights Flashpoint, which is another game I need to play a lot more time. Play. Enemies who hear sound will turn to face it immediately, then move to investigate on their next turn. Okay. So if I select my melee attack, I can go up here and get this guy here.
Okay.
And then they're going to show us how we're going to get an ambush here, aren't they? Oh, 2 damage. Okay.
It's now or never. Weapons
during the ambush turn, your team gains bonus accuracy on their shots. You only get 1 ambush turn per mission, so make most of your advantage while you can. Okay. All right. So now we get a bonus turn, and we got this bozo here. Select your hip fire action. All right. Hip fire costs 1 AP. Use it to rush down your targets and engage them at close range. Okay. And it wants you to go there. Wow, of all places it wants me to go there. So yeah, like, I'd be taking cover over here, but okay. I'll go where you want me to go. Sure. Oh, he's got what, a shotgun?
Barely on solid ground and we're already painting the fields red.
Okay.
Moving out!
Oh, he's gonna get to see him. Select your Overwatch action. Yeah, covers the chosen area. When an enemy enters your Overwatch cone, you can make its attack against him. Love Overwatch. Okay, so. Covers an area and shoots any. Oh, and you want me to Overwatch this. Oh. Okay. Pick a target till set. Oh, so it's a different way to set an Overwatch. It's not entirely like a cone, is it? Oh, okay. Oh, and so we could tell that there's a guy over there from sound. And there's more guys in the house.
I have a target.
Each time an enemy enters your Overwatch cone, you can choose to fire or save your Overwatch for a different target. This target is completely defenseless, so take the opportunity to attack. So if I attack, I just get a hit. Okay.
Bad idea, amigo.
Amigo. And now there comes this loser, and he's going to take
Tom,
cover.
You got a shot on him?
He's in cover, but I reckon I've got an angle.
Yeah, okay. Objects at or below waist height are low cover. Chance to hit a target in low cover is reduced by 30%. Okay. Select your hip fire action. You want me to take a shot from there. It's a 44% hit chance. That's not good. Do you guys not know who I am? Press space to confirm my target. No. No! You knuckleheads. That's not a good shot. Oh no.
Yes.
Okay.
Not a hit.
See?
I'm out!
It's
I have
me!
To reload. Missed. But I spooked him. My turn.
Regardless of whether a shot hits or misses, it deals morale damage to the targets. Oh, that's that purple bar. When any unit falls below 50% morale or below, they are suppressed. Suppressed units have halved AP, reduced accuracy, and deal less morale damage. Oh, wow. Okay. So, select your aimed fire. Man, but he's in cover. I want to move here. How far can I move? This is what? This is what I gotta figure out. So what is this? This is 1, 8. This is 1, 2, and 3. And it says what? 6. What does the 6 mean? Aim fire is costly, but accurate. Use it to suppress your targets and pick off enemies at range. 6 times. So what is this? Hit chance, break target, damage, crit damage, crit percentage, morale damage 4. Where are all the bodies? They disappear conveniently, Chris. He asks in the chat, where are all the bodies? They disappear. It's part of the mechanic of this game. I've heard about this before I got the game. So yeah. We're going to learn how this works here. Of course, it's only 54%, but now he's broken. When a unit's morale falls to 0, it's broken. Broken units skip their next turn. Okay. So that's a type of crowd control. This guy's gonna yell at him.
See if you can flank him.
Why couldn't we flank him before? Oh, so you want me to move there? It's just 3 though. I get what, 2 AP? Okay.
Moving out.
When your weapon is out of ammo, press R or reload button at the bottom of the screen. Yeah, so you flanked, and then it's R to reload. Greater than 5. Oh, so RAP is here, this number. Okay. And this cost, the aim shot costs 6 to shoot. And you can see it cost you 9 to move over there. So all of our movement to get over there. Okay, I got you. So 5 to reload.
Reloading.
All right. And now... flanking basics. Units who are not benefiting from cover are considered to be flanked. Cover icons turn red when flanked. When flanking is suppressed or broken, unit shots against them deal critical damage. Okay. I see. So his cover is red. Okay. So they consider this flanked. Wow. Alright. They're more generous than I would have been. Hit, select hip fire. Let's go then. And it's 1 AP to shoot that one. And we critically hit him, and he's kill confirmed. Okay.
That's more like it. Good shot.
So now, click on the target cell to move. Okay. Wow, this game is really aggressive with its movements.
I see a straggler around back.
All right, so click on the target. You're going to move again? You're brave. That's gonna use up all my movement. Wow, but I guess this guy could come out right away and flank us, so.
Clear that house up, pronto.
He's overwatching the door. I'll find another way in.
Yeah, he's overwatching the door. Okay.
Moving!
At 10 AP, units can break adjacent windows and open adjacent doors. Highlight the adjacent cell and hold blank to interact. Okay. Hold to break. All right, so now we can move here and cover. And that's going to cost us 3 to move, and we can do his hip fire for 1. Wow, hip fire for only 1.
Check your 6, Jerry.
All right.
Ah, Wilco! Last round!
He's dead.
I need a refresh.
Objects at or above high head height or high cover. The chance to hit a target in head cover is reduced by 60%. So flank the enemy where possible. Man. See, if I was designing this game, I'd make that more like 80%. But alright, so we can flank him. It's going to be 5. Move and then it. We can take an aimed shot. Select your aim fire action because this costs 6.
Oh! I'm
and
dry.
He's dead.
Gotta reload.
Okay.
Clear?
Clear.
Clear.
All the bodies, of course.
Which have disappeared. Aside from all the bodies, which have disappeared.
Vincent must be worried sick.
That's interesting. Okay, so. Wow, okay.
After we escaped the dry gulch in the barn, we had to lie low while Adolf's fan club hunted for us. Tom and I shake off the Germans. We strike out to try and find Vincent and our resistance contact, Charles. Vincent's chute came down somewhere near a German radio station. I think things are about to get hotter.
It is interesting, isn't it, Chris? I like the tutorial. I mean, it's very reminiscent of the XCOM one.
So, we're here on the map.
XCOM always had really nice tutorials.
Should have been here by now.
Jockey, this is Rocket. Preparation. We need backup immediately. Kind of version of XCOM, it seems.
Looks like we got a rescue on our hands.
Yeah. Select a mission. The map is divided into 10 regions, each with 3 segments. Highlight a region to learn about its ability. A new mission will appear in your current region, Picardy. Select the mission to continue. The briefing indicates the type of mission. Assault missions begin in combat. Okay, we're familiar with that from XCOM. Ambush missions begin in stealth. We're familiar with that from XCOM 2 with an ambush meter. And stealth missions begin in stealth with unlimited stealth kills and no ambush meter. Oh, fun. Wow. Okay. Select and play the mission. Rewards 10 supplies. Training. Okay, so here we go. Here's all these. Wow. So we're right here. There's the mission. I'm checking this out. I gotta tell you, man, as a veteran myself and a complete geek about Band of Brothers, and of course, my dad's a veteran, my uncle's a veteran, my grandfather is a veteran, having an XCOM-style game in World War II is like, this is stroking an itch here. This is pretty cool. All right, let's do it. Mission briefing. Select an ally. Yeah, all right. So click him. That's cool. God, nice graphics. I like this. It's really clean. It looks nice. Briefing reward. Cassidy and King have to locate Tremblay. However, he's pinned down with your French contact, Belanga. Rally your men and drive the attackers back at all costs. Well, hell yeah, okay. Let's see, defeat the attackers. We get extra XP for these things. No squad members wounded, defeat the enemy attackers, rescue Charles and Vincent. All right, let's do it. Oh my God, is this gonna be my next obsession, is this game?
Vincent's pinned down.
I already have too many now.
We need backup. Let's get him out of there.
There's Enshrouded and Last Epoch and now this, and I still haven't touched Zoria, which I was a Kickstarter backer for. Oh my gosh. Okay. Holy, and so we're on alert, so right away there's no stealth mechanics here. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna look at some controls here. Controls. Pan up, pan down. Is there a pan speed? Oh, you've gotta fix that, people. Come on. It's gotta be a day one thing. Maybe it's here. Horizontal dead zone. What is this? This is the sensitivity threshold before analog sticks accept a horizontal input. No, I'm not using the stick. Show extra set titles. Vertical dead zone. Camera movement speed. Let's do this. Let's do something like that. Now what do we do? That's better. It's still not where it needs to be for me. Like, going to have to go all the way up to 2.0. What? That goes 10 at a time? Okay. You forced me to use the mouse to be precise there. That's better, though. Okay. Oh, yeah. Here we go. And then, oh, yeah. Give me the angle right here. Okay. So I got these losers. Oh, click the target seldom. Oh, we're still doing tutorial stuff? Okay. Is this not good cover right here? It's full cover. Oh, but I'm going to move to half cover. Does that help me shoot better? All right. Units have powerful skills to aid in battle. Using a skill puts it on cooldown. We know that from XCOM, meaning it cannot be used again for a set number of turns. Rally restores the morale of all allied units. This skill is vital for healing suppressed and broken allies. Okay. We had Rally in, what was it? Wasteland 3. It kind of worked a little differently, but oh my God. I want to go back and play Wasteland 3. Somebody pay me enough money to just be able to play video games all day. That'd be great. All right, so now what is it? So this is Rally, the Rally skill. Oh, because our friends are locked down. So they're over there and they have low morale. So you're going to rally them. And apparently it doesn't have a range on it. It's just going to work on everybody. Oh, hell, really?
On your feet, boys. The cavalry's arrived. I've never been so happy to hear an American.
Okay. Cool.
Okay, let's light them up.
It didn't do them 100%. It just did a certain amount. Okay. Unprotected units in the blast radius are automatically hit. Units in the larger frag radius are less likely to hit, but still take full morale damage. Okay. So now you're going to throw a grenade. Oh, sweet. Okay. Grenades. Grenade. Wait a minute. How come I can get morale for all these guys? I want to throw it there. I don't want to throw it here. No, throw it there. Do I have to click the target cell? Because they're going to kill both of these guys. That's why they want you to throw it there. Because if you do it here, it's just full morale damage. And you're going to break... You're not quite going to break two guys. You're going to break one guy. Okay, but here you'll kill two guys. Okay.
What's up, Krauts?
Dead dudes. All right, click on that. Wow, it's really aggressive. Target cell to move. Holy crap, really? You want me to move all the way up there? My XCOM instincts are kicking in and saying, don't do this, but they have a tutorial here. So I guess I gotta trust the tutorial? Oh my gosh. Okay, so who's gonna get a go? We all get a go on our turn, and then they get a go. So it's not like alternating turns or anything. So our inside guys should be able to what? Come out here and flank and shoot these guys? Okay, let's see what they have in store for us, what their tactics are. Each weapon has a cone of fire which may cause damage to units other than your intended target. This applies to friendly units too, so watch out for friendly fire. Okay, and then you're going to do select your hip fire. Oh, it wants you to hip fire him there. Wow, okay.
A message from the king.
Here goes nothing.
Firing a sidearm is often cheaper than reloading your primary weapon. This makes them a good backup option and the cheaper means of attacking weakened or stationary targets. Okay. Oh, and there's an explosive barrel right there. Oh, so we're going to switch over. Select your hip fire. Okay. When aiming, press tab or click blank to click the left mouse button on the enemy to switch targets. Now try selecting the barrel as your target. The barrel!
Can confirm.
Bloody good show!
Oh, jeez, it killed all of them?
We?
Oui? Oh, we got one guy left. Okay, and then you're out the window. Select your aimed fire action. Is it gonna try? How far can you move? You can't move, can you? Oh, but you can get out there. Aimed fire, but you can't get far enough to get that guy, can you? 55% from there. I'm just seeing if I can do anything smarter than the game is going to do. It's 8 to get out there. But then you'll be... Are you flanking him from there? It's 85%. Oh. Because it's saying do this and what? 55. Man. I don't like the idea of 55. How do I back out of... Here's what I want to know is how to undo that. Oh, it doesn't look like I have a choice. Maybe because it's the tutorial. Yeah, see? You're not... Oh, and he's going to go into Overwatch. Oh, and there's a guy back there. Oh, no, this is not good. Ally down. When the health of an allied unit is reduced to zero, they become down. Downed unit can act for 3 turns. After that, they will stand up and rejoin the fight. They will. Unless they're killed, of course. Alright.
Moving out!
9, and then you can hip fire. All sidearms are hip fire weapons. This provides more flexibility to flank with characters whose primary weapon is limited to aim fire. Okay, so it's going to depend on weapon type, because he's got the carbine, so he doesn't have a hip fire. So you go here, and you say yes.
Hey, oh.
Kill him. Okay.
I'm low on ammo.
All right, and then you can flank him really nicely from there.
Moving.
Select your sidearm. Why can't I use my trench gun? How many moves does he have? He's got 6 left. Why would you not want to use your rifle there? He's still got 1 bullet. Okay, it must just be because it's a tutorial thing. All sidearms have the disruption ability. This means that all shots with your sidearm will cancel the target's overwatch, even if you miss. That's also an XCOM thing. Okay.
At your service.
Click on the target cell to move.
All right. Mouvement. This may sting a little.
If a unit takes damage while down, they retreat from battle. Oh, if they take unit, okay. Approach and revive. They don't die. They've got it. They've got to die. Hold to revive.
Yes.
That's an interesting mechanic.
Okay. Thanks. Take care. You cannot afford another wound like that.
Yeah. When a unit is down, they become wounded. If the wounded unit is down again, they will retreat from battle. Retreat, retreat, retreat. Okay, but I'm not seeing anything about death yet. So, you want me to move back here and try to shoot this guy with your pistol? Snipe fire fires a shot that reduces enemy cover and boosts your critical chance. This is a great skill at flushing out well-defended or tough targets. Okay, so you can use this. Select your snipe skill. It costs 6. Oh, and he killed him. Okay.
We're wow. Clear.
Reinforcements.
We're not
what?
Out of the woods yet. Regroup. We got a whole
your mission will often attract the attention of enemy reinforcements. So great. The timer will count down to their arrival. Enemies do not attack in the turn that they arrive. Use the seer advantage and destroy the incoming forces. Okay. Wow.
I caught myself up.
Yeah, so how do you do that? Why do you want me to move there? Click on the target cell.
Moving out. Okay.
Some items in the world can be collected for beneficial effects. Collecting a medkit immediately restores a portion of the character's health. Oh, and so what? Oh, I see.
Just what I was looking for.
I didn't notice it in the world there. Oh, okay. You are free to fight. Saving it and loading is now enabled. Go to war. Oh, okay. Saving and loading? Oh, okay. Objective complete. Where are they going to show up at, the reinforcements? That's what I want to know. Are they going to show up over here? Where are they going to show up at? We have high morale. So where are these bozos going to show up at? Beat the enemy reinforcements. Well, in case, are they going to show up through here? They can't. This is an enclosed area. You would think... I guess go over here. I'm not sure where they're gonna show up at. Okay. Next.
Magazine's
guy.
Almost dry.
Well, then you should reload.
Loading.
And what do you have? Do you have? So, what is over? Is this your Overwatch? Overwatch. Oh, I see. It expands like that. Perfect. Actually, that's probably not a great position for him. Can you get...
Moving!
Well, we'll see what happens here. Okay, you can overwatch too. I don't know where these guys are going to come from, so... Kind of... Taking a chance here. Oh, there they are. He's running, but he's stuck.
Enemy!
Attack or ignore? Let's attack that guy. Don't give him a chance to get into cover.
See a target.
You got 25% chance. Which guy are you shooting or ignoring? The Crown King? Yeah, shoot him.
An old thing. Flank them.
Okay.
There's a buck in my sights.
Yeah. Just the morale.
Flank him.
There we go. We got two guys with who are broken.
Full of piss and vinegar.
Press equal to cycle through enemies on the map. Use this to evaluate the position of remaining threats. Okay. So equal. It's just those three guys. Alright. So.
Yep.
I'm low on ammo.
Yeah, you're low on ammo, but you could go over here and hip fire on a few guys. Not sure that's the wisest thing. What about you? Where are you? You could be over here. Can you just shoot from there? You got to aim and it's six. It's 85 to hit him. And he's vulnerable. And he's the most immediate threat to this guy over here. So I'm going to shoot. A near miss, but now he's broken. Okay. Oh, so even though it cost 6 AP to shoot when he shot, that was the end of his turn. Alrighty. I got ya. What's he got? He's got the carbine. He's got a trench gun. Oh, man. Okay. And he's got this. He's gonna hip fire this thing. Come over here. Enemy.
He fell and flankiert.
Yeah. Like that.
Got it. Fish in a barrel.
He got two of them.
I'm out. I have to reload.
Okay.
You want me?
Yeah, I just want you to shoot this. Oh, you've got this weapon.
Reloading.
Yeah, what do you got here? That's five to reload, and then you can shoot. 59. He's wide open. If you were a quarterback, your name would be Tim Tebow. Okay. 75%. What? Oh, well, it's college fate. Of course it is. Of course it is. He loses his turn, thank goodness. Okay. My friend.
On the horizon,
you idiot. They're not you hit your own guy.
Get out of here.
If we destroy the radio tower, it might buy us enough time to escape.
I've only been in the country for an hour, and you're already speaking my language.
You want to interact with the demolition point to plant an explosive charge. Make sure you clear the blast point before it goes off. Your mission objectives are marked by a cat going through the window trying to blind me here. Your mission objectives are marked with an icon denoting their importance. Complete all primary objectives in order to complete the mission. Extracting previews. You will often be given a preview of the mission's extraction zone. Once your primary objectives are achieved, this is where you'll need to go to complete the mission. Okay. Boys and girls. So there's reinforcements coming here in a turn. And I need someone to interact with that, and then we need to extract over to here. Okay. Overwatch is 3. That's going to cost you 12 to move up to there, and 12 to move up to there, and 4 to move here, and 7 to move there.
Moving!
Can't move over here. And reload your gun.
Reloading!
Two shots. That's tough. You can get through the gate there. I don't like you being so exposed, my friend. You can get through this window, though, so we're gonna do this.
In position!
Okay. You need to be able to shoot somebody, but in order to do that, where do you need to go? Out this way? Oh, crud. Okay. Yeah, that's not a real door. Oh, it is. Oh, I like this. Oh, much better. Okay. You need to reload. Dude, you're gonna reload right there. How much does that give you left? 1 point? Get over here. And they don't shoot on the turn that they show up.
Target!
He's 41%. Skip him.
Target acquired. There's a fucking missile.
And that one we're gonna shoot.
He's having the last bite.
That's nice.
That's a humdinger.
Alright, you.
You need me.
I'm low on ammo.
Wait.
You're going over here.
Au mouvement.
Get moving. She's gonna blow.
Yeah.
We have succeeded. Our escape route is over there.
Okay, clear the blast zone. The extraction appears once all primary objectives are completed. If your whole team is in the extraction zone at the end of your turn, the mission ends successfully. All right, my friend. Get out of here. So you... Well, here's...
What do you need?
I need you to get out of there. Yeah, move like this. Move like Jagger. Get over there. Okay, you've got one shot left on your gun at 84%.
Eat flesh, you bastards!
Near miss!
Last round, I need a refresh!
Loser. 54%, he's 72% from there. Hip fire him. Blast him.
Wilco, I've got a bead on him. Ah,
okay, there we
the
go.
Blighter. That's a clapper.
And we got another group coming in a turn. Okay.
Moving out.
You're moving. I shouldn't need you to load a weapon. You're going to move.
Mag's almost empty. Can I help?
Yes, you can. Get over here.
All mouvement.
They could speed up that hopping through the door animation.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Moving out.
But still, I'm liking what I'm seeing so far. All right, my friend. They're going to be rolling. Hopefully they'll come in through here. Come into the radio tower. I got a present for you. Oh yeah, baby.
Just you try and stop me.
So you should make it.
Magazine's almost dry.
You should make it.
Moving.
I'm low on ammo. Moving.
I don't want to give those guys a chance to shoot me, but do we get any more experience if they die? Demolish the radio.
Oh. All mouvement.
I'm going to wait and see.
Vérifiez votre secteur.
I want to see what happens. How long does it take this thing to blow up?
Augen offen halten.
I'm low on ammo.
Mag's almost empty.
Oui, en mouvement.
Oh, so I still have to end my turn.
En mouvement.
Okay.
She's coming down, fellas.
Okay. Oh, and so we do get a confirmed kill for that. Oh, that's awesome. The tower falls down. Crunch. That was nicely animated.
Welcome to France, my friends. I think I'm going to like it here.
That's cool. I dig it.
An invasion is coming to free Europe from the Nazis. We're here to prepare the ground for D-Day. Our mission is to help the French resistance. To sabotage the Germans and build a secret army of patriots. We will form partisan groups behind enemy lines to tie up the Nazi war machine. When D-Day comes, they'll give our boys a chance to get ashore. That is our goal. Build a strong enough resistance to make this invasion possible. The clock is ticking. This is Willard Cassidy. Out. We just got word of a couple of candidates for our team. Here's some Bolshevik kid. He's got the student groups fighting for him. We have a Moroccan Goumier who's desperate to fight with us. So, who are we going to invite to our party?
Choose one and sacrifice the other. Oh, okay.
Now we are all safe, we should check our equipment. Replacements are hard to find. Make sure you have everything you need.
Gear up review, okay. Recruit, so this is a recruit heavy rendezvous with a Moroccan French named Sammy Alami. He's tipped us off about a supply of detonators being held at a rail yard. The equipment would be useful in days ahead. Intel, recruitment, retrieval, wire. Rewards, an M1 carbine dragoon and a brand new assault. And this one is a student leader. Jacob has been captured and will soon be moved beyond the reach of his allies. Free him. We get the jacket. What is that? Normally I like to blow things up, but I think there's going to be a lot of stealth in this game. And it says refractaire. I'm wondering if it's some kind of stealth jacket. That seems like it might be really useful. So, Let's see, base camp. Tom King and Vincent Tremblay want to talk, gains max morale, and heals fatigue. In the base camp, you can listen to characters talk, which recovers fatigue and boosts their max morale. Select a character to open their loadout, where you can modify their weapon skills and appearance. Okay.
Tom, can you go pack your stuff away from me?
Not like you to get nervous. What spooked you?
Well, I'm aware that you're a walking bomb, and I don't like the casual way you throw that stuff around.
It's all safe, old chum. Time pencils, cortex, blasting caps. It's only dangerous if you don't know how to use it.
Watching you handle it like it was junk gives me the heebie-jeebies. Shoo, go over there.
If it makes you feel better, I'll tinker elsewhere.
Oh, that's cool. Max morale raises to 1. Okay. Cool. So, loadouts. Rally, active skill, unwavering conviction, and passive skill, unique skill. Willard recovers 30% morale after using an active skill. Okay. That's cool. Customize. What are my customize options? Skill grid. Each time a character levels up, they gain a skill point, which can be used to learn new skills. Active skills give characters new actions to perform, while passive skills provide automatic bonuses. You may only learn skills adjacent to skills you have already learned. Oh, okay. All allies recover 50% morale. Okay. Well, and he's got some time before he gets to the next level. Okay. All allies in range 1.5 recover 50% health. He's a medic skill. Oh, so King is a medic. Nice. Okay. Bellinger, shoot your primary weapon with critical chance. Target's cover bonus is reduced, so he's got sniper and Tremblay. Throw a pebble at a target space. Unalerted enemies within range will turn to face it. Oh, we love that. That's a great skill to have. That's cool. Vincent Rocket. Oh, and you can change his code name. Okay. You can change his code name? Oh, really? That's cool. Oh, Crown King. Oh, no. I gotta know what their job is. Belenga. Yeah, zero is good. Jockey. Okay. Wow. I like this. This looks neat. This looks a little bit Far Cry-ish. It's cool. Okay, back. So, customize this. Oh, I see. And so you can choose your weapons. Compare and equip different weaponry. Each character class has a specific weapon type, which only they can equip. Unlock new and better weapons through mission rewards and faction liaisons. Okay. Newest versus... Yeah, so we don't have a lot of choices. It's great. Secondary is this or that. Okay, melee and a grenade. What is this? A satchel charge? Oh, wow. Okay, so I assume Bellinger, what's he got? He's got this, that, that. So that's what's selected. Bellinger. So if we wanted a satchel, and there's a sticky bomb. Anti-tank grenade. This is a grenade coated in glue designed to stick to vehicles and penetrate their armor. It's a very short throw distance. Okay. King just has a standard grenade. So if I wanted him to have a satchel charge, has a large blade, it explodes the turn after it is thrown. Okay. It has an 8 throw range. That has a... okay. Alright. I've got a little bit of a handle on that then. Loadout. Factions. Days until D-Day. Oh, that's awesome. Okay. Cool. So back to the map. Conversation, gear up, review the character weapons, clothes, and skills. We did. Okay. That's cool. Game is smart enough to know we did that. So we're going to go over here and do this one. All right. All of you guys, launch mission. Primary objectives, kill all enemies. Ensure Block survives. Free Jacob Block. Secondary objectives, kill enemies with Block. And free Block without being detected. Okay. I'm all for this. This is really cool. This is my kind of game. I'm digging this. We're 45 minutes into it. I'll probably do this one more mission.
Our boys banged up, and more Germans are en route. Let's bust them out pronto.
Okay, so we're unaware.
You cannot hold me forever.
Oh, that's awesome. Okay, let's see. So we know from doing it earlier, the equal sign will cycle us through known enemies. So there's an enemy there, and there's a very loud explosive thing. There's an enemy over there. There's an enemy over there. One there. Oh, yeah, we could go in guns blazing. Okay. So where is Pebbles?
Yes.
Where is Pebbles? Jockey's here. I'm gonna need Pebbles to keep these guys facing that direction. So this is who? This is Doc. God, and then they could shoot us there. Well, I could get him. Do I still have room to move afterwards? Because it's going to be 8.
Shh. Enemy. Good night.
Stealth takedown, which is good. And then I need to get my guy as far away as possible. Oh, that. So any kind of a kill uses up their action points. Oh, I wish he's wide out there in the open. I don't like that. Okay. That was bad. Pebbles, I may need to get you to move. Where's Pebbles?
Yeah.
You're over here, unfortunately. You're in the wrong place. And I got a guy over here. Dang it. Okay. You go up here and try to get this guy. We have no idea which way this guy's facing.
You want me?
Yeah, I do. I want you to come up here and tell me. Can you tell me where that guy is? It's 11. Can he see you if you move over there? And there's 6. Reinforcements are going to be here in 6. Yeah, it's no good to. Well, hold on. If you can stay in this bush here. If you can be in the bush, you'll be hidden. Oh, man. It's a question of. What's that guy doing over here? All right, come over here. It's half cover no matter what, so.
Moving.
There we go. He spotted, but he's looking the other direction. All right. That's what I needed to know. You can't move. Okay. I'm guessing this bozo is also looking that way. So if we were to go up here, no valid targets. Okay. So I need to move up a little bit. 7, right here, 13. You can't get there. Mm-hmm. You can. No valid targets. Okay. Well then. Pebbles. Yeah. We have to get in position to take this guy out next. What's he overwatching? Because he's looking in that direction. Is that what it means? It must. Or it just means you can't get there. What would this do? Why is that red? Oh, maybe it's explosive? Can I see this guy here? No valid targets. I just need you to move. Distraction. I don't need you to distract.
Yeah. Oh, I'm here.
I just need you to move right up to there. Actually. I'm a little bit concerned.
Moving
I'm gonna
out.
Put him right here.
There's a buck in my sights.
Okay, and it looked like he was facing that way, right? Let's overwatch this way in case the bozo decides
covering
to come
the area.
Through there. I like that you don't have to shoot a guy on Overwatch. So can I be hidden here? Yeah. Well, let's learn some things. Okay. And I've got more enemies. Got this bozo over here and that bozo over there. All right, let's end our turn then. They're just on, they're on patrol. They're turning, they're watching, they're making sure nobody's showing up. He left me. Oh, but there's another bush there. That guy gonna turn around or stay there? And he's gonna do what? He's gonna stay right there. And there's a guy back here. Here, heavy, cannot be stealth killed, deals high morale damage, can sustain Overwatch. Oh, look at him. Oh, and he was right near that can. We need to get him.
You can kill me, but the people will never be silenced.
Enemy reinforcements arrive in 5, so we gotta kill people really, really fast. We need him to move back over to this thing so we can blow him up. That guy, if he turns on us, that would be really, really bad. Can I stealth kill this guy? I can, but then can I get out of trouble? Yeah, right there. And there's noise, and nobody's gonna hear it. Alright, let's do it then. Let's try to figure this game out.
You're mine.
Okay. This guy can see over in this direction, I'm sure, so we can't stealth kill him there. This guy's right here, but we might be able to stealth kill him.
You need me?
This? You need me?
No. Okay. Need to figure out. There we go. Can I do this? Can I see him from here?
I'm moving. Moving out.
Oh, he's facing the wrong way. Okay, hold on. We can do this, though. Let's do this. Oh, this would be nice. We have to get him in that zone right there. So does that count? If we do this, we need to move him over there. Does that work? It does. Can we throw it over there? Can we throw it there? We'd have to move a little bit, wouldn't we? I just need him to face away. When do I end up in his field of view? Right here? Okay.
I'm moving.
Can I get a better aim here? Right. Doink. Doesn't appear to do what I wanted it to do. That's unfortunate. Oh, but I can still stealth kill him now? Okay, what the hell? That's what I want.
Fresh quarry. I got him.
Keep it up.
I like this mechanic. It adds a lot of stress here early in the game when you're like, I need to try and stealth kill as many people as I can. Let's get into cover over here with you.
What is it?
Right there. It's either that or I feel like I'd be committing too many people over in this direction. And I need you to be out of sight in case this guy turns around or that guy turns around. So,
moving out
here. Now, you can overwatch, but that doesn't mean anything. I'm only gonna overwatch if he moves up here close enough to.
Checking my sector!
Long pause for sneezes. Okay. So you're just gonna stay right there because you're hidden. And this guy would probably see you. So I'm just gonna leave you there. And he's gonna stay there. Let's end turn. Yeah. Got another guy back there. Guy inside the house. He's turned towards the house. He's guarding. That guy's turning in that direction. He's going to keep walking. Too bad there wasn't a barrel right next to those two guys. Okay, there's the heavy right by his barrel. Man. How many quiet kills can we get? Can we get any?
Hey, yeah.
We need three more quiet kills. I'm not sure we can get them. Can you get this guy? Yes.
I'm gonna skin you alive.
Remember, he can't be killed by stealth. He can't be killed by stealth in this guy here.
Yes.
You can go over there. Okay, then go. He can cross that little river. That's cute. Okay. You can be in this bush. Man. Because, yeah, if we stealth kill, he's going to be, this guy's going to be wide open. So we're just going to do this.
What's up?
And then we need you to hide. Probably, that's the blast radius of this thing. Would get where? It'd probably hit us. We probably need to be right here. And we're going to get reinforcements in what? Four turns? He turned away instead of walking over here. That's nice. Inside the guard. He's going to keep walking. He's going to walk right by us. Oh, he's right there. Oh, and he's going to walk away again. No, I wanted to blow him up with the barrel. I need pebbles to make this guy turn. Now, he can get cover there. Get half cover there. Can he toss this over? Nope, not quite.
Moving out.
I need you to toss it. Oh, through the window, you can get it over there. Yes! Hold on then. Okay. Can you get that guy from right there? Yes. Oh, in fact, you could sneak up and get this guy. Oh, but you don't have a safe spot. Yeah, just snag this guy. Okay. Corpse disappears. And he stays in his cover. That's the best part about that. I could, theoretically, move up here. It'd still take two turns, though. It'd take two turns to move and move out of the way. And have this guy look off in a different direction and come over here and snipe that. I only need one more. I only need one more sniper kill. That is going to put me in danger, but I can hit this guy here. Okay, do it. See what happens.
He's down. Super.
Okay, I'm excited. Yes. Oh, now the ambush automatically starts. Okay. Son of a gun. It's not what I had intended. I should have waited a turn. That's okay. free block without being detected, so I failed that.
At your service.
Yep.
All right, so there's that guy there.
What's cooking?
He's a heavy and he's got a lot of hit points. Look at that. That's why I wanted him over here. Dang nabbit. Son of a gun, if I'd have waited a half a turn, I would have been good. Okay, so if I move over here, I'm at 92% right there, but then I'm exposed through that window. I don't like that. What am I at to hit this guy right now? I'm at 89% to hit him. Okay, hold on. 89% to hit. I'd like to be a little better off than that.
Wait.
What about you? You've got... That would take him down a good chunk. And then he'd still be on this side with cover away from those guys. Okay, make it happen. So his morale's down. Okay. Now you, what do you got? You're at 100% with 20 crit damage, and you'll knock his morale down.
How'd you like this? Bullseye.
Oh, nice.
Good shooting.
Okay, and he's suppressed now, which is great. That's what we needed. Okay, because what I want to do is be on this side of the cover.
Moving out.
The guy from meine Flanke an.
From this guy.
Meine Flanke ist offen.
And I want to take this guy out.
Yes! Yep. I've got him lined up.
Here
he's gone for a Burton.
Snipe!
Okay, nice. Now, you should be able to take cover right there. Yep.
Moving okay. out! Ich werde flankiert!
Yep.
Sure. Enemy!
Criticaled him!
Nice kid.
Key dropped by the enemies. We know we got that guy over there who's going to come around the corner there. And that guy lost his turn, and he's going to move over here by the explosive.
Here, my revolutionary brother.
Oh, I'm having a blast with this. Okay. Let's see about you. You've got two more bullets. You could try to take him out, or you could just hit that.
Firing! I love it when they go boom!
Magnifique!
Oh, it didn't hit him! Oh, crud! Okay. I thought he was close enough for that to happen. Oh, son of a gun. Okay. You're at 23%. Can you overwatch him? Overwatch in that direction. You can come around the corner here and flank this guy.
What's the plan?
This. How much cover do you need? Right here. You're at 84% right there to hit him, and we know the tank isn't going to blow us up, so might as well go here. He wasn't inside the orange blast range. I didn't see the orange blast range, so I need to be... Like, let's take a look at this. Okay, so it's showing right there, the red-orange blast range. Okay. Okay, that's cool. Well, in that case, now I see it. Now I understand. He's 84%.
Can confirm. He's in my sights! Hilfe! Hilfe!
His morale is down. He's suppressed. Okay. You could get up here far enough, but you couldn't get a shot at him, can you? I need you to get in here and get the key then. Can you go through this window? Yeah. Oh, I love the way they do... I love the way they do the window breaking. So they're like, you gotta be sure that that's what you want to do. Oh, and now I can't see in this. Get me in there.
Moving out.
Okay, right Moving. There. Who's left? I got 1 point left. Let's go.
Ich schaffe das.
L'ennemi approche.
Yes, hit him. I love that you have an option on Overwatch whether to shoot or not. How are we liking this so far, Scott says. Worth dipping into? 100%. I'm 100% loving it. It's very XCOM-ish in the terms of the way the rules are done, the tactics, but there's a few little twists that I'm really, really, really liking. Chris says, not a big fan of the bodies just vanishing. Not too sure about being able to do stealth attacks from the sides. Just feels a bit off. Eh. I don't know. That's like a low complaint item for me. Like, that's so far down the list. I'm not caring. I'm having too much fun. I mean, you sound like you're way more of the hardcore, I'm going to play XCOM on the absolutely hardest difficulty in Iron Man mode kind of person, and that's just not my bag. I'm liking this. This is actually fun. It's like not straining my brain.
Magazine's almost dry.
All right. What's next? We got to kill this guy. That's the problem. Because he's got cover.
I'm low on ammo.
Yeah. Well, yeah, because there's no stealth attacks now. You could go up there and knife him. And that would cause him to... That would cause him to lose his morale and skip a turn, which would make it pretty easy to kill him off the next turn.
I'm low on ammo.
Yeah, you are low on ammo. You get one shot. You go up there. What do you need to shoot him? 46% versus reloading or versus getting full cover. Where there's a bunch of... Oh, and these guys are coming in a turn. Oh, let's do this. Scott says there are like 5 DLC plans. Just wonder how much it will change replayability, etc. Well, and I just bought the season pass for it because I figured you said on Twitter there were 5 DLCs, and I thought if there's 5 DLCs, then I'm just buying a season pass. I want it all. So, yeah, we'll see how much it changes over time, and maybe 1,001 people will complain about the bodies disappearing. I mean, I could see. It seems natural to leave them in so that if somebody detected the body, but then you have to do the whole hide mechanics with it. You know, you got to be able to drag bodies and all that kind of stuff. And maybe they'll change, because it's a little awkward that after you perform an attack, even if you have free AP, you don't get a move. Like, you don't get a move into cover afterwards because you made an attack. So maybe they'll change all of that. I don't know. But on the surface, the way it's playing right now, I'm enjoying it. This guy needs to reload. Let's do this.
Reloading.
And then I'm gonna have him do this. Can't really get too much over here, so let's do
checking there. My sector.
You gotta get the key. So get the
moving
key.
Out.
And you have to hold it to grab it, and I like that. And can you get over here? Hold to open.
Moving.
Freedom at last. You are real heroes.
I'm trying to be.
Now let us eradicate these foes together.
Okay. I'm gonna need you back in this direction because we gotta be in position to shoot these guys in the other direction. But first. He's 55% chance to hit this guy, which is just not good. You can get out here and you can actually open this door. Are mods a thing? Most games. I mean, it's brand new, so I would imagine people will mod it. They mod XCOM. Even a game like XCOM that's not made for mods, if they know what engine it's built on, like if it's built on Unity or whatever, then somebody will figure it out.
I'll move more.
But being so new, it's not gonna have mods yet. Now we could grenade this guy. I'm kind of okay with that because if we grenade him. It's not going to destroy cover, is it? And what's his skills? What's this skill here? What's this skill? Rally. Okay, we don't have anybody with low morale, so I'm just going to toss this. Okay, His morale is down and he's basically done.
What do you need?
Can you kill him?
Moving
if you
out.
Can't, he's gonna skip a turn.
The guy from meine Flanke an.
You're must
stark bleiben. Weiterkämpfen.
Okay. That guy's taken care of. Let's get out here then. We need to get somewhere up here and cover. Let's go. I find myself wanting to target those to see what the blast radius is like. So he could sit there and not be in the blast radius. Okay. But he can't quite get to there. He's gonna move here. Yeah. We know the enemies are coming. They're gonna be right there.
Enemy sighted.
Oh, they're here.
Taking the shot. Oh, he's full of lead.
Clean kill.
Enemy reinforcements.
Pause to sit on und denk an deine Ausbildung. Ich kämpfe weiter.
I'm low on ammo.
We? Mag's almost empty.
Can you knife him again and finish him off? Yes. The morale effect is really cool. That's like an extra layer. And you know what it reminds me of a little bit? It's like the two layer of armor in Divinity Original Sin 2 between physical armor and magical armor. I like having dual systems like that that allow you to do different things. This is really cool. Scott Graziano says, the beauty of the low hits is you still affect morale and have opportunity to change things, right? Exactly. You have opportunity to use morale to cause a guy to skip a turn. I think that's huge. So, I like that a lot. It makes it so you don't have to play the XCOM way, which is being forced to kill targets every single turn. It's like, you've got to kill somebody or you're dead. Here, if you don't get a guy dead, you can still neutralize him. You could still do crowd control, which is my favorite thing in all these kinds of games, is figuring out ways to do crowd control.
You want me?
Who?
I do, but I want you
at
guys
your
to...
service.
Who do we...
At your service.
Yeah, so you... I want you... up here where? Can you get up here? Up there? What's the blast radius on this thing? You're fine there. Okay, go over here.
I'll move more.
All right, so you're right there.
What's up?
I need you to move out of the way, really, so you can flank this guy. Seems like it would be a good thing to do.
Move it, target.
I don't want this bozo down here to flank me, though. Can I go even further? It costs 6 to shoot this thing, and what is he at? He's at 6. Okay. 84 to hit him.
Eat lead, you bastards! Hilfe!
He's suppressed.
Moving
yeah,
out!
Yeah, sure. Move on over there. What are you... You're gonna need to reload soon, but you can.
Wait!
That guy's right there, and that guy's there. Hold on. This will give you full cover?
All movement!
Satchel charge.
Satchel charge!
I like the way he said that. Great. Okay. You got 3. You can overwatch, but that's not gonna do anything. Can you...
Moving.
You should have to run this direction. You're right there. You're gonna stay. What I have? 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. 0, 0, 0, 0. He's like, I'm getting away from the satchel charge. This guy's like, so am I. And he's gonna come around. I figured he was gonna do that. He's gonna try to flank, and he's gonna get me on the flank. Okay. So they got. So if you want to flush people out, throw a satchel charge. Because it goes off the next turn. That's awesome. I don't want to hit my own guy here.
magazine's almost dry.
I know. Yeah. Can you hit him? Or you need to be up close anyway. Oh, you'll hit your own guy if you do that. He's got what? Not that. Oh, what? Oh, you have to move over here. Okay.
All movement.
Now you can see. Wait a minute. What's going on? Why are you? Oh, you still can't see this guy from there? Oh, because the rock formation. Okay. Oh, geez. From there you can see him. Now it'll cost you 5 to move.
All movement.
Okay, let's do that.
Meine Flanke ist offen.
Right there. See if you can kill him. Near miss. Oh, but he's broken, so he'll skip his turn. That's good. Okay. He's gonna skip his turn. So if I go up there, it's red cover because of this guy behind me, but it's still cover from this guy. And I've got one bullet, and then I'm gonna have to reload.
Ich werde flankiert.
Do your best.
How'd you like this, Sonny? I'm dry. Okay. Gotta reload.
Yep. If I move you up there, if I move you right there, you can't see. Okay. Yikes! There's no cover. There's no real cover there. He'll hit his own guy with this shotgun, won't he?
Moving out.
He's got one shot too.
The guy from meiner Flanke an.
Doesn't look like he'll hit any of his friends.
Roger. Taking the shot. Oh! Enemy down. Last round. I need a refresh.
He's gone belly up.
I like that. Okay.
Moving.
Way up here.
Yes, who's comrade. Left?
You. Yeah. There's a guy way over here. We gotta get up here and try to handle him.
I'll move.
It's 9 to move up there. He's got fresh ammo. So we can do... That stretches quite a long way.
Primed and ready!
Okay. You've got one left. Nobody else has got anything left. End of turn. That blows up. It damages that vehicle a lot.
I'm good.
Oh, no! I'm pinned down. That blows up. That's cool. Okay, I can move in that direction, but I need to reload. So... let's reload first.
Changing mag.
Hackmaniac says, yeah, I win a lot of battles by breaking the enemy's morale. I can't see what that other word was. It's, I think it says AOW, but the heart is in the way on YouTube, so... thanks, YouTube. Let's see, where do we want to go? Where do we want to get me? What cover can we get behind from here? We can't really. It's not going to be easy. We can go here.
Move it.
Let's do that.
Weapons dry.
Weapons dry.
Loading.
Okay.
Moving.
Head up there.
My clip's almost empty.
Yeah, but it's not empty, so.
All movement.
Here we go. Like this. You, my friend. How long would... where can you go? You can go right there.
Moving out.
We established that that's a safe spot.
You want me?
I do. Oh, and you can see that guy from way over there? 6 won't get you a shot at him, and this is full cover, so we'll just move over here. What can we do? We can stretch it over to there. Okay. It's going to be a low percentage chance hit, I'm sure, but... he's trying to decide what to do.
Jeez,
Oh no.
Get off, Willard.
Okay. Where's my guy? It's Jock. Jockey has this morale thing. Yeah, the trumpet. I don't really need it yet though.
Who? Me?
He's got the trench gun. I need to get him around. Wait a minute, does anybody have... Okay, hold on.
I'm low on ammo! I'm low on ammo!
You're low on ammo. Okay. This thing is destroyed.
Moving.
I'm gonna move him over there. I'm gonna try to flush these guys out here.
Oh! Oh!
Use your trumpet power.
Fuck up! We're still in the game!
God's got a plan for me. This ain't how I die.
Cause what I want to do is throw this grenade.
Grenade! Galata! We got a pin! Flank him!
There we go. I don't think he's gonna... Is there only one... Is there... There's... Can he walk through there? He can. You can walk right up there. Yeah, so you gotta have some cover.
Moving out!
What's it take to throw a grenade? It's 3. Oh. Okay, next. In that case, you can march all the way over here.
Oh, move on.
Do it. We're gonna flank these guys.
When the flank is open!
Yep. You still have 2 points? No, you don't. Okay. And you're way over here.
Get over.
That is everybody. Yeah, you're gonna miss me there, buddy. I got cover. And it's a long shot.
Too close.
Okay. He doesn't have a grenade to toss, does he? No, because we used his. But we have his, and he's got the trench gun, so we can either try and shoot these guys, or we can try and toss this grenade. We can't get it in there from there, can we? Can we see anybody from here? We can't? Really?
Moving.
Okay.
Watching.
I'm just gonna roll like that.
My clip's almost empty.
Yeah, but it's not, so... What are you to shoot? 85%? Take the shot!
Attack! Bon voyage! Last round! I need to reload!
I know.
You are good.
I should have reloaded
fascists.
Him first. I gotta get used to this idea that he's gonna shoot and have AP left and not be able to do anything with it. So. That's.
Moving out!
Go up here.
He's better flanked.
Yep.
Right like that. Covered. Moving out.
He decides to run that way. We're gonna toast him with the mosty.
Primed and ready.
Overwatch him, boys. What's he gonna do? Oh yeah, he can move.
Thank you, friends. When we fight as one, no force can stop us.
And Sherblock survives now. Cool. Oh my gosh. Yeah, like I'm totally gonna play through this whole campaign. This thing's awesome. The jacket refractaire clothing top. Okay. And everybody made a level. Nice. Cool. We start the mission? No. I will take that. That's awesome.
I am Jacob Bloch. I'm a Jew. Collaborators, particularly in the police, have been arresting Jews on German orders. My cousins were sent to labor camps. The rest of my family wore the yellow star,
or went underground as I did. Many Frenchmen were happy to purge the Jews. It was us, the students, the Marxists, who wanted to fight. We organized the first resistance. The capitalist Americans and British have come to fight the Germans. When we win, we will ask them to leave. If they refuse, we'll turn and fight them too.
Very cool. Okay. Wow. Gain that. What is this thing? A lined black leather jacket and fingerless woolen gloves. Cool. Okay. Supplies gain. I have a cat's wet nose touching my toes. I really like how they play with the art as they tell the stories, Hackmanic says. It's a neat way to do it. It is. It's really cool. Put real artists to work. Jacob Block has joined the team. Region strength. The radicals gain one region strength. That's cool. Nice cat. Hey! Stop that. Stop scratching that. Being a turkey. Sometimes I wish I had a webcam not for my face, but for my cat. That's the only reason I'd have a webcam. Increasing region strength. After each successful mission, the associated faction gains region strength in a location of your choice. If a region strength increases to 3, you unlock its ability. Oh, cool. Like XCOM. I love it. They borrowed everything from XCOM, but they've turned it on its head slightly, which is cool. A region strength also fills the resistance strength bar at the top of the screen, which contributes towards a D-Day victory. Nice. Excellent. Wow. Fill all 3 segments of a region and unlock its ability. Okay, cool. So this is hospital time for the cure injuries task is reduced by 2 days. So we can see, okay. Hit and run. Enemy movement time is increased by 1 day. A home base allows our troops to form bonds with resistance comrades, increasing their connection to the people we fight for at the center. This is aid. All allies gain +5 max morale. Okay, cool. 2 arms. Complete 2 more missions. Rewards, 10 supplies. Good afternoon from California, Dirk Dwipple says. Good afternoon, chat. Dirk, nice of you to be here. How's California this morning? It's got to be nicer than where I am, although we have nice weather today, but man, it's been cold for so long. So this is cool. Okay. Wow. I'm digging it. So I got to complete 2 more missions. Okay, so let's go to... Gain a foothold. Okay. Baby steps. That's our first resistance network founded. Success breeds support, and each mission we win draws more resistance to the cause. We need more support, though. We can raise networks in all 3 parts of this region. We'll get special aid, so build your networks carefully.
There's a pair of resistance contacts eager to join our little soiree. There's an Australian guy who has parachuted in and needs a hand. This guy comes with a reputation as a hoodlum. Do we want him?
Oh, really?
So? Who gets the ticket for the Jedburgh Express, nonstop to Berlin?
D-Day in 51 days. The Allied Expeditionary Air Force is undertaking thousands of photographic flights across France, taking vital pictures of beaches, installations, and bases. Supplemented by intelligence reports from spies and the resistance, a picture of the German defenses begins to form at Allied headquarters in England. Oh, cool.
There are many resistance groups. They all want help and weapons. You will have to balance their demands.
Factions. There are 3 factions in the resistance, the radicals, the Gaullists, and the criminals. You have a relationship with each faction that increases after each successful mission. Criminals. What can the criminals give us? Oh, wow. Cool. Okay, so what is this? Recruit support. A petty criminal named Henry Vittel is offered to help infiltrate a logistical hub. Get access to the Wehrmacht's fueling schedule and wiretap their communications. Okay. Get a couple of pistols. And what do we get over here? A digger slouch hat. Recruit. A Jedburg named Ollie Johnson parachuted in yesterday. The Germans have him cornered at a church. Get to him and see that he joins us. Recruit heavy. Well, we could use a heavy. We could use a heavy, but let's go back to base camp and see what's going on here. Willard and Charles.
Willard, no more jokes. When will the invasion come?
You know as much as I do. Late spring, early summer. Soon.
You've seen the Sea de France. What if the Germans throw the invasion off the beaches?
Then I guess Eisenhower will try again. Look, Charles, Anzio showed we've gotten good at this. What's the worry?
That we repeat Dieppe. Then we have to wait for another campaign season, another year. That the Red Army will liberate France before the Americans.
You know, we Jeds are here as pathfinders. We're here to make it happen.
I know, but my fear is that we do not do enough.
So this has me really curious about, like, Scott, you said there's 5 DLC coming. And it's 51 days until D-Day. Is like D-Day supposed to be the end game of the main campaign, and then the DLCs are going to be everything that takes place after D-Day from the war? Like, are we going to get a DLC for Bastogne? You know, it's like, wow. Dirk says it's mostly sunny and 64 degrees in California. Since I voted for this, I should join in the experience. Oh, you mean you voted for France 44 in the poll that I put up? That's cool. This was definitely something that I wanted to look at, and it wasn't even on my radar until the beginning of this week. I think I saw a tweet and I was like, oh yeah, I've had that game wishlisted for a while. And so I was thankful that it got mentioned, because it jogged my memory, and this is very cool. Okay, well then. Secret Army. Activate an asset by filling all 3 rewards in a single region. Okay. Form your battalions. Review factions. Okay. Increasing your relationship with these factions unlocks new weapons and clothing items. These can then be purchased with supplies. Make sure to check with the liaison regularly for a new kit. Okay. See, this is going to be part of figuring out the game, is figuring out which faction you really want to bump up, because who has the rewards that are going to benefit you the most, because they're not all going to be equal. So here's our factions.
Bienvenue. What can I tempt you with?
I see. Oh, so this is the Walter PPK compact, and this is what you get for it. It's got a little more damage, a little more morale damage, and better accuracy. And you can purchase it for supplies, which we have 44. Oh my gosh. So now I gotta figure out. And they're hostile. So we need to...
Bonjour.
These guys are hostile. They have the Thompson. That's cool. And then what's this at level 2? What are these guys considered? Hostile. Suspicious. Oh, that's funny. Cautious, indifferent, cordial, helpful, friendly. Oh, so you get better stuff the better. Oh, wow. And loyal. Oh my gosh. This is a cool system. I dig this. Oh, I dig this a lot. Wow. I like it. The UI is really clean. The colors are distinct. It's been really smooth to play. I mean, right off the bat, I'm loving the game. Hackmanic says, I thought it said you can play as 3 different factions. Did it give you the option at the beginning, or do you have to unlock it? It didn't say that I could play as 3 different factions. It says there's 3 different factions in the game, but you just start out as this, as you start out as the Inglorious Bastards. That's what it is. There's a little intro movie that played before I was able to get the recording going. So there's a little intro movie at the start of the game, and it tells you what you are, and you basically are this covert Inglorious Bastards group. The 3 factions that I think are, this is it. I didn't say you could play as any of these factions, so Dirk says, I watched Mingles with Jingles. He received a gift box from the publisher of the game. So when asked, what do you want to watch? Scott says, it looks pretty sharp. Excited to see more and pick it up myself. Yeah, I mean, if you're an XCOM fan, if you like those kinds of games, which I love them, and I really would like to, I would really like to do an XCOM 1 playthrough on my channel. I started one a long time ago, and then the mission that always goes bad for me went really bad for me, so it ended. I've had a lot of successful Iron Man runs with that game, but for whatever, I knew when I started playing it on YouTube, I knew that was going to hurt me, and that's what happened. Complete two more missions. Okay, activate an asset by filling in a region. Yeah, all right. Complete two more missions. So I want this heavy over here. Although the criminal. Let's go into the factions and see about weapons real quick. Like here.
Bonjour. I'll make you a good deal.
Yeah, see, without any knowledge, it's hard to know what things would be worth here.
If they find British or Americans wearing French colors, they will call you a spy.
I wonder if we'll be able to move all of these up over time. That would be cool. Scott says, that was a rage quit. Yes, it was a rage quit. Well, I mean, I had to. It was like, it wiped my team out. And the funny thing is, I can't tell you how many times I've played XCOM 1 Enemy Within, because I play it with that DLC, and I love the Enemy Within DLC. And I can't tell you how many times I've played it on Iron Man mode and made darn near flawless runs. And I might lose one or two soldiers the whole entire game. And then I thought, okay, but it had been a long time since I'd played that game, so I'd forgotten exactly where the enemies drop on that one really hard mission. And then I had really bad shots. I mean, I was missing 75% shots and stuff like that as usual. So, it just went badly, but I would like to record another one of the series. And I think the way I would do it this time is that I would record the whole series. And if it went well, then I would just upload it all at once. And then members could binge watch it. And I'd put it on some kind of release schedule. Heckmanic says, I dare you to try an impossible run on XCOM. No, that'll never happen. If you thought missing a high percent shot was bad, just wait till you get a hit for one. No, that'll never happen. I have zero desire to punish myself playing video games. I do this for fun because everything else in my life is already punishing enough. Like, life is an impossible run. Real life is impossible run. On Iron Man mode, you get one save file. And it's impossible. So I don't want to do that. Play games to have fun. Normal mode is good for me on almost everything. The most punishing things that I've ever played that I stuck with and ended up enjoying were Elden Ring and Dark Souls 3. Because those are the only two Souls-like games I've ever played. And if it wouldn't have been for Elden Ring as the gateway drug, I would have never played Dark Souls 3. And I only stuck with that because I thought, I really want to learn how to get better at this type of game so that I can kick Elden Ring's butt. Because I started with Elden Ring, then I switched over to Dark Souls 3 to get good, and then I went back to Elden Ring and was like, okay, this is awesome. I get it. And Elden Ring is still one of my favorite games of all time. I was listening to my review of it the other day because somebody made a comment after a long time. And it's really interesting going back and listening to those reviews. Listening to those reviews after all that time and seeing that, you know, that was my impression of the game at the time. So it's like a time capsule. And I still was like, yeah, it was accurate at the time. But if I were to do another review of Elden Ring now, I'd be way more effusive than I was because I just ended up adoring that game. So Cassidy, let's see. Who do we want to take care of? I got nobody wounded, so I can take whoever I want. Hold to customize. Who do I got here? Pebbles is Tremblay. Okay. Tremblay, you have to go. I need you. Need Belenga. Take our original three guys. Block, you can stay here. Let's launch this. We'll do one more mission. Heck, Manic says, the first time I played XCOM on the PS, it was the most difficult normal mode, and that is still true on the remake. You know, and it is. And when they added the DLC... Oh, this is going to be cool. I like this. We're going to get a little animation here.
Christ, talk. More of them.
Oh, geez. And we're on...
You're the cavalry. Yeah. How about you lend me a hand?
We're on the... There's no sneak attacks here in this one. When they added that DLC, and so there's a couple of missions in there that I think are part of the DLC that have to do with you eventually trying to break out a psionic person. And so it starts with the really hard mission where you have to go into an area that's been completely destroyed, and you have to sneak your way in there and kill the aliens along the way and talk to a contact, and then you have to get the contact back to the extraction zone and all those. And it's one of the first missions, I think, where the thin men show up, and so they're just they're destroying everything. And if you don't know exactly where everybody drops on the map as you're going backwards, because it's still so early in the game, you guys just get wiped out. And then the mission after that that's also hard is the train one, which is now you have the information and you got to get on the train, and you have 10 turns to get to the end of the train. And if you just don't have your crew geared up by then, it's really, really hard, and you end up losing people. And so if you can get through I always feel like if I can get through those two missions, then the game is cake from that point. Like, then you get the big mission where you have the alien spaceship, where you're going in and it's your first time going on a big alien spaceship, and you have to deal with the disc alien for the first time. And if you can get through that, you get so many resources that it like boosts your research, and you can build a whole bunch of stuff really fast. And from that point on, the difficulty tapers off. You know, it's that reverse difficulty curve. It's really hard at the beginning, and it gets easier as it goes along. And that's what I love about the XCOM games, is that once you get geared up and you have enough tools and enough skills, then it gets really fun. And then the only time you're going to lose somebody is because you were stupid, you know? Yeah, the thin men are a pain. Feel like they never miss a shot early on. And that's because they don't, because they're actually technically boosted. They get huge... They get huge boosts to their accuracy. So that's why you have to take them out as fast as you can, because even if you're behind cover, they're going to nail you. And that's the hard part with them. So here... All right, so we know from experience... that if we drop a shape charge out here, or whatever that thing was called, not a shape charge, but a satchel charge, these guys will scatter like the wind. So we got guys in the open. Okay, let's... He's the satchel charge guy. Okay, I gotta get him in position to hit a bunch of people from behind cover. Or these bozos. Okay. So who's satchel charge guy? It's him? Zero. Zero has the satchel charge. Okay. Yeah, he says. I can get him up there. I get him behind full cover. I get him behind full cover, and he can shoot somebody. Oh, but he's got the Thompson, so he needs to be kind of close, doesn't he? So you got what? You're six. You can move way up there, but that's 12 to get to cover. You can move up there, and that's 12, and then everything is half cover. Yikes. Okay, and then there's that. So you're the least useful one right now. And he's the heavy, and he's got this, the Bren Mark II. Oh my god, okay. And what's he got over here? He's got a sticky grenade. Oh, he's got a... Yeah, throw a sticky bomb. Okay. Oh, I like this. We're gonna have a heavy. Okay. Okay. Yep. So I've got you... Cassidy. How far up can you get before you can shoot? There's an 8. That's not going to do it. What about here? 5, and then you can shoot. Move yes, it. Please. Okay. Yep, take him out, will you? You're 65% or 64.
Firing! Oh, God!
Okay. He's suppressed... Well then, and then this is, he's got the trench gun, so he also needs to get up close. I'm gonna put you right up there. That's 50%. That's 20. 20. 20. Nobody's in the blast radius. Okay, take a shot at him.
I got a bead on him.
Nine.
So more suppression on him, and then we get him. And I want to throw a satchel charge at these guys if I can. How much to show the, throw the satchel charge? 3? So I gotta get somewhere where I can get to 9. 9. And you're 12 over there.
Okay.
Sie greifen meine Flanke an.
How far can you throw it? You can't throw it far enough. Or if they were gonna take cover, that'd be a waste though. They're not gonna rot, they're not gonna walk into it. Let's do this. Yeah. Alright, so you got the Thompson. I can put you right there. You'd probably hit your own guy with that. Let's go back here to Heavy Dude. Mr. Heavy. You can get up there and move, and it's 6 for you to shoot your weapon. But you're gonna be kinda... Yeah.
Move it! Meine Flanke ist offen!
I'm not worried about him. You're 25 for him. You're 24 for him. And 23 for him. All these guys are gonna take a bunch of morale damage. Bunch of morale damage. So which guy? Hold on. Which guy? Hold on. I only got what? 2 guys left?
Yep.
Okay.
What's the plan?
So you got to come up here and do something with somebody. Man, he could hit it. He hit his own guy there. That's the problem, isn't it? He's going to hit his own guy. Long way to go, pony.
Moving.
All right, let's move him up here.
Ich werde flankiert.
Hackmanix is I'm having flashbacks to an XCOM mission here, and I don't mind one bit. Exactly. This is kind of fantastic. Okay, so I want to take a shot at somebody. That guy's suppressed. This guy's suppressed. I need to suppress somebody on this right side here. Or I can do this. No, I'd rather suppress. Let's do that.
Friendly fire.
Let's do that guy.
Take this. Oh, hey, throw a 7. Clean kill.
Oh, he killed him. Okay.
I have a target.
You do have a target. Let's leave him. Oh, because he got the barrel.
Enemy approach.
Yeah, attack him.
Attack! Enemy down.
He's down.
Snipe! Anger. I am heat.
Oh, I am heat. Okay.
I'm low on ammo.
Yeah, you are, but can you... You get the trench gun. That's the problem. Can you shoot the trench gun at that guy? Yes, and he's inside the blast radius.
Yes! I got him lined up. Oh! Back the blighter. I'm out. I have
nice.
To reload.
That's fine.
A humdinger.
That's fine. You reload. We're good.
Moving out. Sie greifen meine Flanke an.
Low percentage shot. Oh, but he crit him. Okay, that means we can start trying to flank this guy over here. Yes, I do.
Moving out.
We got really good cover. Where are our reinforcements going to come from? It hasn't said yet, has it? But they're going to come. You could toss this grenade.
He's having the last bite. Superb.
Okay, kill enemies with explosives. 2 of 3. Okay, that's cool. Break enemies with Johnson. Who's left? Where's... There's nobody left. Looks like the game doesn't recognize who is playing yet. Acmatics. I know, yeah, right? I'm getting criticals. It's not supposed to happen that way. Okay. Where's our boy? Where's...
What do you want?
Bag's almost empty.
Jockey. Okay, you're over there. Alright. Let's reload you. Oh, you can't. Can you reload? What are you at? You're fully loaded. You might as well reload. Reinforce his position. Okay.
Looks like he brought Jerry to the party. Take position and don't be shy with the machine guns. I think we'll need them.
Okay, this is what I wanted to know, is where were these bozos coming? All right,
I have to reload.
Yeah.
Wait.
You've got the satchel charge, bud. What's it take to throw it? It takes a 3. I can give you what? A 9 right there? Yes, get behind full cover and toss this bad boy.
Time to charge.
Let them run into that. Okay. You need to reload.
Reloading!
And where can you get to? Right there?
Moving!
Checking my sector.
Yep. And then you guys. Can... 8 AP insufficient. There's a machine gun here, though. Oh my gosh. Okay. What other machine? And there's a machine gun there? Oh my god, really? Are you telling me that I can use fixed position machine guns? I'm gonna be very happy. Okay.
What do you need?
I need you to get up here, at least.
Moving!
Yeah, get up there. Okay, insufficient MP. You're on the Bren, so I want to do this. Yeah, you got 2 points left and you need 3. You got 9.
Ready.
You got 12. Get over here.
Moving.
I know. It's okay.
Reloading.
You're not going to reload, but you're going to use this gun next turn, so... Enemy turn. Got a guy on the other side of that truck.
Target.
Oh, leave him. He's gonna run right in. He's gonna be right in the blast radius.
I have a target.
Yep, give him a shot.
Oh, he's full of lead. Nice kid.
Okay.
Oh. Can I help?
Yeah.
So can you use this thing? Hold to fire.
Roger. Sure.
Holy cow.
Can't confirm. I'll run.
That is awesome. Oh my god. That is one of the coolest features I've seen. Oh shit. That is so cool. Okay. We got a bozo way back there.
Let's cook it. Who? Me? Oh. Yep. Yep.
I need you. Can you fire this big machine gun into this thing and make it, yeah.
Take a bomb.
Let's get it hot. Let's try to blow it up next turn. You should just be able to take this guy out.
How'd you like this?
Stock bleiben. Weiterkämpfen.
Broken, so he skips a turn. Okay.
Moving out. I've got a target.
Okay, there we go. There's 2 targets up there.
Checking my sector.
What do you got? Can you shoot this guy? Oh no, you can't see him. Let's go right here.
En mouvement. Oh God, mich hat's erwischt.
Chris says, "And I'm sold." Yes, the machine guns did it. That's just the best thing. Oh my God, it's so awesome. Oh, guys coming in from that side. Come on, you guys want to come closer? I know you do. Oh, nice. Oh my God. For that, you're getting a machine gun, that's for sure. Oh, and his morale is down. No. True grit. Heal? Whoa. Kill enemies with explosives. We met that one. That's cool. Okay, over here.
What's the plan? What do you want?
Right, the plan is for this.
Move it! Okay. Roger!
Yes! Sure. Kill confirmed. Oh my God. I'm loving this. You guys, this is the coolest thing ever. Oh my gosh. Can you shoot this rig and blow it up now? You can kill him. Yeah, just get him. It's 20%. I just want you to hit the rig. You can't see the rig. Oh, I keep doing that. Okay, that'll allow you to see it. Moving. And go like this. There you go. Can you blow that up?
Roger. Taking the shot.
Yes! Destruction! Oh, it's McDonald's. I'm loving it. Okay. We're gonna put you over here.
Moving out.
Yep. And you're there.
At your service.
We got guys coming in from this direction, so we're gonna smack them down.
En mouvement. Vérifiez votre secteur.
Bring it on. I am so stoked for this.
Moving out.
Bring it on. I got nobody left. Let's just do it. Oh, we got some guys over there. I didn't see them coming. Oh, well. Enemy reinforcements have arrived.
Target sighted. Enemy sighted.
Yeah, I got a grenade with your name on it.
Dead man walking. You hit me, you swine! Oh God, that did.
You hit me, you swine. Does this give you option to... Yeah, so when Overwatch trips, you have the option to either not shoot or shoot, which is awesome. I mean, there's no other way to say it. That is fantastic. Oh, it's a smart game. It's a really smart game. Okay.
Magazine's almost dry. Wait.
You're over here, but I need you to be in position to not get shot at. So let's do... I don't know. What's the best case scenario here? We could move you here. And then what? Oh, you don't have a grenade. What is this? Sniper. Shoot the primary weapon to critical chance. Okay. I don't need to do that. I need someone else. I need
you
someone else
me?
With a grenade.
I'm low on ammo.
Yeah, but you got a grenade. This guy's got a grenade. And he's got rally. Okay, we're gonna train places. He's gonna go over here.
Move it.
Hackmanic says, but if you choose no, does it go away for the turn or will it trigger? It'll trigger on the next guy, it looks like. That's what it looks like to me. It'll trigger on the next guy, so you're good. Oh, this is gonna drop morale and it's gonna kill one guy. Oh, it's gonna kill both of them.
Frag out! In that
go- oh! Like yes! We love it. Okay, what do we have? We have a guy out in the open here and. Dude.
Yeah?
Hold to fire. Okay. Oh no, my own guy's in the way.
Roger!
sure.
Oh, we didn't get anybody. Okay. Well, it's been fun up to that point. I've really enjoyed that little piece of artillery there. That's awesome.
Covering the area.
Okay, so we'll do this. We'll cover fire him.
I'm ready.
We need to get you behind cover.
Moving
Let's
out.
Do this. What do you got? You need to reload. Or you can try shooting that truck. I don't think that's the best option. Yeah, that's not the best option. Let's do this. Let's reload.
Closing.
And then if we need to. We can do something like this. We know we still got a bozo coming from that direction. These two guys are dead. He's got plenty of room here.
I am in position.
And he's got wait. He's got the Thompson. Move over here, bud. We're gonna want to be able to do this thing.
In position.
Okay.
Dead man walking.
Yeah, so I'm gonna shoot this guy.
Firing.
Oh, and we got his friend too because of the arc.
I'm dry. I gotta reload.
Parfait. Target.
Fair dinkum, mate. Cheers, Cobber.
True grit. I like that. I like this true grit
what
thing.
Do you need?
I need you to do this, bud. You ready? Have fun.
Roger. Sure.
Goodness, Del.
Can confirm.
His morale's down and he got hit. Oh, and man, that's so good. He's 85% to smack him. Get him. Whoa! Near miss! But at least he's broken. Jeez. Near miss. Okay. I see how we're gonna play this.
Moving out! Meine Flank ist offen.
You got one shot left, but you only got five, so all you can really do is reload or do this.
Area covered.
We're gonna take care of that guy. Is there anybody over here? We killed everybody over here, didn't we? Okay, and what is this? This is all allies in range, 1.5, recover 50% health. All allies in range. Who else is hurt? That guy is. Let's go over here. 1.5, I don't know what that
is.
It's got two left. Who's got substantial? He's got this left. Okay. Reload. True get, recover one health each turn. Wow. That's awesome.
I have a target! Taking the shot! Oh!
He and he's
bar.
Dead!
Last round, I need a refresh!
So sterb ich nicht.
I like this guy's true grit thing. Alright, so he's right there, but
yep.
We're not- before we snipe this guy to death,
Roger.
We have to do the fun thing.
Sure!
My sector is clear. What about yours?
This
that was a bit hairy, mate.
Is badass.
For a moment, I thought I was going to be buried here. So, guess I'm tagging along with you lot.
Indomitable, cannot be broken.
Lisa, we had some good hunting there.
This game is fucking awesome. Oh my god, I love it. This is fantastic. Oh, so he needed to break enemies. I got you. He's too busy killing him with the machine guns. Ollie, my man. You're a badass. This is great. Oh, and more levels. Oh, and I didn't even do anything with levels last time. I need to give these guys some skills. Let's do some skills. What do you guys think? Is it cool?
I'm Second Lieutenant Oliver Johnson. And I was parachuted into this shit show by a roundabout route.
From the militia, I joined 17th Brigade back in 40. And a year later, I was in Syria, in a scrap with the Vichy. I led a section into the Sydney Smith Barracks in Beirut and accepted the surrender of the base commandant. Now, here I am in France, fighting alongside the Frogs, and no one's more surprised than me. When I talk to the French about what I did in the Middle East, they seem as happy as Larry. Death to Laval, they shout. These folks loathe Vichy, only a little less than they hate the Germans. It's a funny old world.
Heck, Mannequin Chat says, I'm looking forward to a new series. I think this is the start of video one. I don't think I want to replay this intro. I think I'm just going to use this stream video as the first one. we're gonna put it in a playlist and go, because this is fantastic. This is a lot of fun. Wow. Oh my gosh. Region strength gain. Criminals gain one region strength. View their skills and equipment and load up menus. Yeah. 32 supplies. Okay, we need to level some people up. Wow. Ekmanic says it'll be interesting to see what the replayability looks like thus far. It looks a bit too structured for too many replays. I think the same thing can be said at the beginning of XCOM ones, though, too, so we'll see. The early XCOM missions are kind of all ducks in a row thing, especially if you're playing the tutorial, and we played the tutorial in this, so. I mean, every single game that I have ever replayed over and over and over and over has repeatable parts. You know, Fallout 4, you gotta get out of the vault. I mean, and you gotta go save Preston Garvey. And then the game opens up. Skyrim, you gotta run through the first dungeon, pick a side, escape the dragon, make it to Rivervale or whatever it's called, Riverwood. And then you gotta go up to the first big dungeon there, kill the boss, bring the dragon tablet back, go to Whitewind, drop that off with the Jarl. And then after you become the Dragonborn and go defeat the first dragon and report back to him and get your first shout, then the game opens up, you know? So they're all very linear up to a certain point. And that's true of so many games. So this part doesn't bother me. I want to see what it's like towards the end, but you could see how we're going to get to choose which regions to start doing things in here pretty soon. And it's going to be like XCOM. So I think this little bit here in the beginning isn't necessarily indicative of how the whole game is going to roll, but let's go. Okay. So select a criminal region to strengthen, fill in all 3-6. So this region. Elite. What? Resistance strength plus 4. Or this. This is the part I don't get. So select a criminal region to strengthen. Fill in all 3 segments of region to unlock its ability. This is... Oh, so these are the only 2 criminal regions. This one. Elite. Or this one. Preparation. On ambush turns, morale damage is increased by 50%. And I imagine that the enemies are going to start to get, like, we saw the heavy and it had like 12 hit points compared to all the rest of the soldiers had 2. I imagine we're going to start running into soldiers that have a lot more morale too. So being able to do that will be good. And then here, resistance strength plus 4. Okay. Okay. It seems like the smart thing to do and do this one though. Bonus resistance strength award.
There's a factory here, upgrading Tiger tanks. We need to scope this out. Now the team is bigger. We can rest folks up or send them out on tasks. We'll need to rotate people through the line.
That was something that was also in Lamplighter League, which is another really cool turn-based tactical game that I need to get back to playing and make a series for. I really enjoyed my time with that one. I got through about the first 4 or 5 hours of it, and I love it. And that's what you do as your team grows. They start sending people out on tasks. So the character suffers an injury if their health or morale is reduced to zero. These injuries lower their stats. Send them on a cure injuries task to recover. Each character in a mission also suffers one fatigue, reducing their AP. Leave a character out of mission and they will recover all fatigue. So that's cool. That's a way to rotate them through. I like that because here's the thing that you run into with games like XCOM, where you build your team and you're so focused on getting them experience and leveling them up to make them powerful that you end up taking the same four and then later six characters along. And everybody else in your roster kind of sits there doing nothing. And then if one of your elite soldiers dies, now you have a rookie with no skills, really, to go out there and try to use. And so for the first few missions with them, they're like the handicap. It's like five people doing the mission and the sixth one is a tag along. And so any kind of a mechanic that forces you to rotate through your roster a little bit, I think is pretty cool. Tasks allow your team members to act outside of missions, healing injuries, gaining experience, and even reallocating their skills. Deploy units by activating the tasks menu at the top of the page. Okay. Tasks and objectives. Complete a task. Okay, but we're going to go to base camp first. Chris says, do you like the skills already? I don't know. I need to do the skills. So we're going to listen to this real quick, and then we're going to do skills.
Charles, I don't understand why we can't stay long at farmhouses. There's a lot to be said for a solid roof over my head.
They are very insecure, mon brave. News travels fast. Maybe the wife does a friend in confidence, or someone looks into the farmer's fields. The locals gossip. Yes. And even if they're friendly, the news may be overheard by someone who is not.
That explains why we're always on the move. No rest for the wicked.
It's safest deep in the forest. Only Maquis and Hunters go there.
And they heal one fatigue for that. That's cool. Okay, let's do this. Click to customize. Let's go through our soldiers then. Let's look at their skills. So you can only do ones that are adjacent to ones that you've already had selected. So that's why they're slightly different. There's a grayness here. So he has this unwavering conviction. Willard recovers 30% morale after using an active skill. And there's this, use self rally. And then over here, aimed fire accuracy plus 5 and firearms. And then he could move up to these other ones. Melee skill. Each point of melee skill increases the damage you deal with melee attacks by 1 and reduces the incoming damage for enemy melee attacks by 1. I could see where that would be useful on stealth missions because you're going to start running into harder enemies, I would assume. Reset the cooldowns of all allies each time an objective is completed.
Whoa!
That's going to be powerful. Okay. Crack shot. 40% with your primary weapon. Effect chance determines the likelihood of a weapon triggering its special effect when it hits. This already I could tell. Resetting cooldowns? Are you kidding me? Yeah, I'll be aiming for that. Oh my gosh. Okay. So he has rally. And we can grab this. Willard recovers morale after using an active skill. This is a real leadership thing here. So we can. So learn skill. So this is learnt. It says, and here we would have to learn it. Self-rally. Recover 50% morale for himself. Okay. Sure. And he's still got another skill point. So then you can learn any of the ones that are adjacent. You can learn this. Hip fire accuracy, maximum health, and maximum morale. Wow. I want to go up this tree to here, though. What's this? Sidearm damage plus 1. Maximum morale plus 5. So maximum morale down there or maximum morale up here. There's no reason to go down here and get this. If you kill an enemy with your primary weapon, you need an AP remaining. The AP is not spent and your turn continues. Whoa, that's what I've been talking about. Okay, so you can do it by getting skills. Oh God, okay. That's so smart then. That's a smart way to design it. It's really going to be really limiting in the beginning of the game, but then this is going to open the game up. You can... And your turn continues? Yeah, we have to have that. Okay, so I gotta go both down this hero and officer. I gotta go down this side too. Oh my God, okay. Oh, wow, there's gonna be... it's gonna be a matter of how many How many skills can you get? But that... No, I want that too. Okay. Well... Bummer. What's this? Effect chance. 20% with your primary weapon. Okay. So this is maximum morale. Wow. We learned that one. We could learn this one. Or we're going to have to go in two different directions. What's this? Active skill cost are reduced by 1 AP. Oh my god. That's awesome too. Oh jeez. Good luck prioritizing those. That's the best video games make it hard for you to choose. There should be no obvious path through this skill tree. You should be able to see a benefit to doing all of them. But that's really hard to balance. That's hard to do. So, Willard, my friend. Nice. And then I can just select the next guy. Yes! Awesome. I don't have to back out or anything. Okay, so what's he got? He's a medic. And he's got this. Tom is immune to critical hits even when vulnerable. Sweet. Good job, medic. Opportunist. So what are his big ones? Target ally recovers 100 health. Accuracy against vulnerable targets. All allies gain plus 50% critical chance until the end of the turn. This bonus is doubled against flank targets. Oh, yes. And then up here. All allies in range 1.5 recover 100 health. AP plus 6 after using the medic. Take your meds or quit missing about skills. What? Revive all down allies. They recover. Oh, my God. Okay. Revolve all down allies. They recover 50% health. Yes. Learn that skill. Okay, my friend. And then you got more skill points. You can get grenade throw range plus 2, maximum morale, or each point. Yeah, or melee skill. Let's do that. Oh my god. These are going to be fun. These are going to be really fun. So he is a sniper at level 1. Now we got to look for the sniper stuff. Gain 6 AP. Can you imagine? Be like, yeah, I could shoot again. Armor piercing. When shooting, each point of armor piercing ignores one armor. Shoot your primary weapon with critical chance. 80 targets cover bonus is reduced by 30%. Oh. Pinning fire. Shoot at a target to inflict stun. While a unit is afflicted with stun status, their AP is reduced to 0 at the start of their turn. Wow. Rifle damage. So for the sniper, he's got to go up here to get fusilade. Well then, we're going to do that. Cover bonus. Learn that skill, my friend. I want to get up here to this. He's got maximum morale and then aimed fire accuracy plus 5. He's a sniper. So let's make him accurate, because I'm not. He's got 3 skill points. Tremblay. What's he got in the corners? Reset all cooldowns of a target ally. Cannot reset the cooldown of move out. Submachine gun, critical chance. Yeah, he's got the submachine gun. Dodge, what is this? After AP 6 after killing an enemy with a melee attack. Whoa. Assassin? Yes, please. Yes, please. I don't even need to think about that. I want to be able to do that. Dodge, maximum morale. AP 3 after killing. Wow, so you can get that. Dodge is a chance to evade all incoming firearm attacks. Inactive if the unit is broken or stunned. It's only 15% chance. I don't know about that. Probably rather have the morale. Oh, and does he have one more point? He does. So then he can do this. 3 AP after killing an enemy with a melee attack. Oh, but it costs 2. Okay. I'm going to save that point then. Block. Reset the cooldown of all allies. So we want to go for that on these guys. I want that one. All allies recover 100% morale. Morale. Target ally gains 6 AP. He can give 6 AP to someone else. That's really nice. Crack shot. Resetting cooldown seems like a really good idea. He's got 0 skill points used, and then there's Johnson. What's he got for this? Tank, fortified. While a unit is enhanced with a fortified status, incoming damage is reduced by 2. Okay. If you break an enemy with your primary weapon and you have AP remaining, that AP is not spent and your turn continues. Maximum once per turn. Subsequent shots inflict stunned on all units in the spray zone. Oh, no way. Oh. Firing your primary weapon does not end Overwatch. Oh my god, so you could Overwatch again? Oh, Jesus. Behemoth. AP is not reduced when suppressed. Light machine gun damage. Oh my god, he's got a bunch of good ones in the corner, doesn't he? Holy crap. This, though, Bullet Storm. Your shots inflict disrupted on the target enemy and all enemies. When the disrupted status is inflicted, the target's Overwatch is canceled. Supplies even as... Yeah, I want to do that. Then he doesn't have to do it with a pistol, he can do it with his main weapon. Morale. Passive morale recovery 5% is the percentage of maximum morale that a unit regains on the beginning of their turn. The base value is 15%, so he gains more of that. And then 50% health. Let's go like this. Okay. That's cool. I mean, who knows what the best builds are right now, but I don't care. This is fun. Oh my gosh. Okay, my friends. So, tasks. Cure to injuries. Oh, so this is what? These guys have... What's the one down here? I gotta look on my guys. So what is this? What's this say? Max AP is reduced by 1. Because they're fatigued. Okay. I got you. Because they're fatigued. Well. Cure injuries. Cured of all our injuries. We don't have anybody that's injured though. Repair region. One destroyed region segment. Wow. Training. The assigned unit gains a bunch of XP. Retraining. The assigned unit regains all spent skill points. Oh, that's cool. So there you go. There's your respec. You just need to run a task for it. Aid faction awards 9 relationship with the chosen faction. Okay. So if I deploy, let's see. Because he's got fatigue, does a task count against that? Even when resting, we must hone our skills and prepare for the trials ahead. Let's do... Hope this game is good, Number Rabbit says. Dude, I've been playing it for 2 hours and I love it. Let's do block. Let's give him some XP. Okay. So back to objectives. Man, I was going to take a break here. It's 2:30, but... let's do one more mission. Complete a task. Activate an asset by filling in all 3 parts of the region. Okay, so then what do we have? So there's this. We needed this. Mission brief. A French factory is upgrading German panzers. Ooh, okay. Let's do this. Tommy. Task will be canceled. Tremblay, you're out. Okay, so I want... Bellinger, I want... He's training. I want you. You. Your AP is going to be reduced. Tremblay. Cassidy. I need loadouts here. Bellinger. Let's see. Johnson. Yeah, what do you got? What do you... You get a grenade and a sticky bomb. Okay, that's what I needed to... Alright, let's do it then. So I need you, 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 and you. You guys ready to go? Primary mission, steal the tank schematics, kill enemies without being detected, extract quickly. Well, we'll give it a shot. Scott says it's 5:30 Eastern, but I really like it's 6:30 with Spring Ahead tomorrow. But really, like 6:30 with Spring Ahead tomorrow. Yeah. That's right.
They're upgrading Tiger tanks.
Let's snaffle the schematics before the natives turn hostile.
This is a stealth mission. You can perform as an unlimited number of stealth kills, but be aware, if you are detected, you cannot return to stealth. Okay. So I got three guys here. Where are my enemies? Those are the only two we can see? Okay. Well then.
You want me?
Yeah. I can see that guy in there. Okay, so if I go up here and stealth kill this guy, is there anybody else over here? That's the thing, the fog of war is going to be. Ooh, I can see this getting me scared right off the bat, huh?
Yes. How you going?
Okay.
Nice move. Oh, fuck.
Okay, so now we got extra guys.
Yeah. Right. I'm here.
You have this ability to throw things and make guys turn the other way, so we're going to want to do that. What's this cost? It costs one. We're going to have to do that and get those guys going in the other direction.
What's up?
I'm going to wisely move him.
Moving out. Target in sight.
Okay, so there's an enemy over there. You can kill this guy, and if he doesn't turn, if he turns, we're screwed, but. Still take down number one. Okay, head over there. You can get that right there, and it'll affect both those guys, and they'll turn in that direction. Okay, they're distracted. Good.
Can I help?
Yeah, maybe.
Moving.
All right. Anybody else got any points left? You're there. Yeah.
Moving.
Nobody else has really got any points left. Okay. He's going in that direction. That's good. And he's going where? Yikes. And then there's another guy there. Okay. Stealthy missions.
G'day.
Yeah, I know. You're gonna have to get way over here, bud. Crud. Oh, but you can drop down here? Oh, that's nice. Okay.
Nice move. You need me?
Yes, I do. I need you. Oh, and there's two guys over there. Okay. Is he going to come back this way? It's a question of who's going to turn around first, isn't it?
Moving out. Shh, I see him.
Yeah, I know you see him. Oh, and there's a guy up there, too. Okay. Well. Can it be used by a detected character? Does not affect Overwatch enemies. Unalerted enemies. Can I throw this pebble and get this guy to head in that direction? What was that, he says?
Yes.
Problem is, where is this gonna go? He didn't go anywhere this turn. So I'm gonna send this guy over here. I can't get this dude. I'm just gonna leave him here. Oh no. Oh, okay. No, that was impossible. Oh my gosh. Here, sapper. Cannot be stealth killed. Okay. Explodes on death. Resilient to explosive damage. Oh my god. Unlimited grenades. Okay. Oh jeez. What's that guy gonna do? Is he gonna go somewhere? He's a sniper on Overwatch. That's why he can see into here. This guy's looking in this direction. Can you get him? Can you get him right there? Yes. Take him out. Alright. So it's a stealth mission.
He's down. Nice kid.
Man. Look at this. This is like Mission Impossible here.
Yeah.
I need you to do this again. He's distracted. Man, if he kills this guy here and this guy comes back in this direction, I am screwed. What about him? About that guy, unlimited grenades, man. Gosh, I don't like being right there. That guy doesn't turn around and go back the other direction. I'm so dead. You gotta do it though, because he's gonna wander back in this direction.
He's finished.
This is when having that extra move would be great, though. That extra AP. Okay.
I'm moving. I'm gonna skin you alive.
Gotta get up the stairs and get that other guy. And he's overwatching this area right here. Okay, so you... Where's that guy gonna go to? Do we think? And there's a dude right there. Okay, I'm gonna move here. Oh, he had his back turned. That's okay. That's what we needed to know. Yep, he sees me. Oh no, it's bad. The stealth is over.
Beast! Bloody hell!
Oh my god. Okay. He's very resistant to, yeah, and I knew he was gonna get hit. He's gonna get hit by the sniper.
Stellung halten.
And he's got bad cover situation. Bad cover situations everywhere from trying to do the stealth. Oh no, and there's another guy there, and he's gonna get a shot off him.
Jesus!
Oh. It's bad, folks. It's bad.
Kontrolliere deinen Bereich.
So it's like XCOM with better cover and better zoom in and out. Number Rabbit says, yeah, it's a lot like XCOM. Yes, it's got some different rules about cover. It's got a morale system, so that's what the purple bar is for. So you can make guys lose their turn by having low morale. So let's see. Let's go. Yeah, you've got. Where do we want to go with you? Because he's got 6 AP to shoot. That gets him 7. That's not good enough. I'd have to go right there. There's half cover there. You can start trying to shoot that guy. Okay, let's do it. Kill enemies without being detected. We needed to kill 8 of them, and we did not, so. Oh, wait a minute. He's only got 5 left? Oh, what? Oh, darn it. Okay. In that case, we're going to do this. Let's see. You're in a really good position.
What's the plan?
I need you to get behind cover. Preferably, you can see, he can see you from there. What about here? It's 5-1. You got the Thompson. You can run up there, but I don't want you to. It's only 40% to hit that guy from there. Number Rabbit says, I will have to watch from the beginning. Yeah, you will, because there's a lot of cool stuff
you
in
want
here.
Me?
Okay. Oh, man. He's got a grenade. I love. Does he have a grenade? He does. I'd love to get over here and chuck a grenade on those guys. So let's try to do that. Grenade costs 3 to toss. I don't have enough. Okay, right there is 9. And I got 11, though. No good. No bueno. Okay. Alright, let's start with him then. Because if I can kill this guy, this changes everything. He's got his rifle. He's got an aimed shot. Not that guy. This guy right here.
Attack!
Okay, he's dead.
Knocked him for 6.
That's nice, because then what I can do is put this guy somewhere like here. That's going from 11 to 9. He needs 3 to throw the grenade. That's still too much. Let's do this then. Can I toss this in such a way right there?
Throwing grenade.
It'll take care of that guy, and it should hurt the other guy.
Touchdown.
And it killed both of them. Okay. Okay, that helps. What about here? 60%. I need to kill this heavy dude. Okay, let's do this. I don't like any of my cover options here.
Moving out. Here.
You got 5, and you got this to shoot. It's only 40%, but drop his morale.
Taking the shot.
His morale is down, so he's going to be suppressed. Okay. And now it's their turn. They're going to go, and we have a chance to overwatch him. So.
They took that pill in the head. Go!
Nice. He's almost dead.
Fire! Mary, mother of God. Fire! Too close.
Okay, yep. His morale is going to go down. Oh,
enemy.
Dude. I'm going to flank the hell out of you, but he's kind of already flanking me.
Let's see if I can hit a ton.
Yep, let's see if you can. What are you, you're 84% right there to hit that
Moving
guy.
Out.
Oh, that's why I've got 11. I got minus 1 AP because he's fatigued from the prior mission. Okay. 84 to crit.
He's done for. That's a clapper.
Number Rabbit says, are your percentages shot and misses better or worse than other games? So far, it's been better. I think it was Hack Manic that set up further in the chat that the game doesn't understand who's playing it yet because it's me. So I should be routinely missing 75% shots and I'm not. It could just be beginner's luck. But I think they're right. The game just doesn't know that it's me playing it yet. They'll get there.
What's the plan?
All right. You have this chance. Let's see. You could switch to that. And what's it like to shoot that? 1? It's 42% chance. Don't do that then. Switch back over and use your big bad boy. 55%. Hit him. The big weapon here. Big weapon has a low 55%. Oh, and he explodes. That's right. Remember, those guys explode when they get hit. So that's cool. They explode when they get hit. Okay. So, right there. Wait a minute.
What do you need?
Yeah, I need you to shoot that guy up there. What? There's too much glass here. Max. What is he to hit this guy from here? 35%. 35, 35, 35. 46. It's marginally better. What about him? What are you to hit him? You're at 59% to hit him from there. And what is this? This raises your chance because he's a sniper. Yes. He's got the sniper ability. Take him out.
down.
Yes. Nice. Okay, you can come over here. Do anything. What do you got? You got one to hit him. You only need one to fire your gun. Or you can go in Overwatch with three. So let's do
moving.
This. If he wants to shoot us from there, he can.
Covering the area. Target acquired.
Nail him.
Fire.
His morale is low. He's suppressed. Near miss.
Enemy
oh, and
sighted.
Here we go. This loser. And another loser up top. Oh my god, thank god I have a sniper. And
target
another loser
sighted.
Right there. Oh, look at him.
Fire.
No! Oh no. Okay, my friend. What do you have here? This is self-rally, and this is rally. Yes, rally everybody,
don't get
please.
Soft on me. We're not done for yet.
God's got a plan for me. This ain't how I die.
It ain't how you die. Well,
wait.
You're gonna find out about that. Okay. We know how to do this. We got this shape charge. That's not gonna hit me, is it? No. These guys will bail and run because of the shape charge. So they are going to completely take off because they don't like that idea.
Max almost empty.
Well, I need you to get up here. What is it to shoot? One?
Moving
okay,
out.
Go.
The guy from Meine Flankern.
Meine Flankern. Do it. No, well, that's a really good shot right there. What's the other one? 66? Man, he's the guy we need to take out, though. That, though, is really... Like, he's... debilitated.
Sure.
Shoot this guy.
Hit the.
Okay, that was nice.
Gotta reload.
All right, so you, then... What do you got? You got one left, and it costs six to shoot. So I need you to... not go very far. Or chuck a grenade. So if you get up there, okay, here we go. You're gonna go over here, and you're gonna use Overwatch. Get ready. And then you are gonna do the same thing, just Overwatch, my man. Except, let's see, can we move you? Nope, just Overwatch. Just do this. These guys are gonna move. They really want to get out of there.
Taking my sector.
They want to move because of that satchel charge.
Dead
so.
Man walking.
Yes, kill him.
It's up with us. Firing.
Near miss. But he's broken, so he loses his turn. And then he's going to get taken out. Sure.
Taking the shot. So knap.
Oh, and he cut away. He's like, away from the satchel charge. Away. Oh yeah, he doesn't want to have anything to do with that. That's a good way to get people out of there.
Can I help?
Yes, you can. Will you do a series, Rumba Rabbit says. All this is just you chilling out. Well, today is about just showing off games, so I wanted to get into Zoria Age of Shattering later tonight. If people want to see a series for this, I'm totally up for doing it, because I think it's awesome, so...
Mag dry.
Your mag is dry, you punk. What do you got here? Can you?
I gotta reload.
Mag's almost empty.
Oh yeah.
Okay. So if I can you shoot somebody, you can take him out. It's 42% chance. Okay. What about over here? I need to get this stuff here. Oh, it's way over there. Okay. So let's do. What's the Thompson issue? One.
Moving.
Let's do this.
Meine Flanke ist offen.
Scott says you have sold me on the season pass. Loving the content. Thanks, man. Ammo, reload weapon. Oh no, shoot him then. Shoot him with the pistol.
Can confirm. Stark bleiben.
But his morale's all the way down, so he misses his turn because he's broken now. Okay. You need to be upstairs, I think. mean, these guys are going to come back, but I don't want you anywhere in that blast radius. Think. He ran out through there, and then there's a guy right there. I think the thing to do. This, what are you at? You're at 12, and this would give you 3. Go right here. Go like this. Okay. You need to
reload.
You're going to reload, and then what do we want to do? Can we move you up here? And you're 5 and 6. You reloaded, so you only have 7 points. So let's just do this.
I'm in posse.
Hack Manic says, I'd love a series on this one. Maybe not the first time through, though. Scott says, I'm also interested in Zoria. Good day to hang out. Yeah. So, I'm going to get done playing this one. I'm going to get a snack and fold over my laundry. We're going to get done with this mission, and then I'll bring Zoria online, and we'll play for a little bit until dinner. So, here. Let's see. Right there is protection. But the question is,
move it.
I'm going to move here. I'm going to move here because I'm going to try to kill this guy.
Eat bread, you bastards.
Okay.
999.
He's suppressed, but
macht es das aufhört. Lass mich approach.
Yes, attack.
Auf zu zittern und denk an deine Ausbildung.
He's going to get a shot at me, which is no good. Oh, no, he's going to take off. Now he's going to shoot me. I'm covered. Smart boy. There goes my morale. Some of it.
Meine Kameraden zählen auf mich. I'm low on ammo.
Yeah, I know you are, but if you move 7 up there, it's 6 to shoot.
I gotta reload.
Can you kill this guy already?
Changing mag.
Take your Thompson and finish him off, because you could kill a lot of guys right here from this elevated position, dude. So I need you to do that.
Roger. Taking the shot. Oh!
There you go.
Bit the bullet. Super.
I am super.
Yep.
All right. Let's go. It's what? 6 and 6. You have 25% chance to shoot him. But even if you miss, you can move his morale down.
Take this.
Oh, no, he actually got him. No. David Lawson enters the chat and says, have you ever looked at kenshi? Is that Japanese cuisine? I have no idea what that is. I assume it's a video game, but I don't know what kind it would be. You are the sniper. Can you get him? Yes. And this is on cooldown for one more turn.
Me to it. I'm out.
Yes.
That's a humdinger.
Okay. We have this loser, and you need to reload, dude. So reload, and then get somewhere more protective, like there. All right. No points left.
Sie dürfen uns nicht besiegen. Ich lade nach.
You sons of bitches can't keep me down.
You can't keep me down. Steal the tank schematics. Okay. Well, that would be priority number one. There's some over there. There's some over there. I got. Oh, did we kill those guys?
What do you want?
I need to get these tank schematics, buddy. Insufficient, it says. All right, get over there. Get over there, Mr. Insufficient. You can move up here.
All movement.
Oh, you needed to reload, but that's okay. We'll get you next turn. Where can we put you? Right here? Alright, can you do him in? Maybe. I love the way their Overwatch works. That's cool. Seeing those squares, it's like crystal clear what the hell's going on. Can we grab that one?
Moving out.
Yes.
Just what I was looking
for. All right, so it costs 1 AP to grab that. That's awesome.
Shuffled us. I have a target.
Take him. Okay, but he's gonna miss a turn because his morale's down, so we're gonna do this. Flanky, flanky.
Checking my sector.
You needed to reload.
Reloading!
Gentlemen, where is our escape hatch here? How are we getting out of here? You're gonna grab this.
This swag's mine!
The swag. Alright. But have no effect.
Moving! Changing mag!
It's an RPG of sorts, David says, for Kenshi. Okay, but here's the thing. Is it a Japanese RPG? Because it sounds like a Japanese RPG. And if it is, I have zero interest. That has a, and it's really weird because there's certain kind of Japanese anime that I really, really love, but I have
moving.
I have zero love for Japanese RPGs.
Moving out.
Okay, so he can get over there to heal, but he needs an AP to do it. And I know tons of people who love Japanese RPGs and they love Final Fantasy and they love swords the size of the Eiffel Tower, but it is not me. Okay, so what is it? Is this health? What is this?
I cannot make it. Yeah?
AP, that'll have no effect because he's healthy. And that's our escape route. Okay.
Move it!
You're gonna come over here and you're gonna go like this.
Covering the area.
And you're gonna run your butt down
en mouvement
to get over there and get healed.
Yep.
And you are gonna heal yourself.
Just what I was looking for.
And get these last schematics.
Moving.
We're almost out of here, boys.
Now, root out is that a one? Moving out.
I'm low on ammo.
Yeah, I know you are, but you gotta. Did you not kill that guy? That's a criminal offense.
Military police. Be careful.
Military police.
We gotta end this quick.
I have a phone. I should just look up what Kenshi is. This is an anti-partisan veteran. Oh my goodness. Shots can inflict disoriented. Oh no.
Dead man walking.
Okay, kill him then.
Firing. Punished.
Fresh target. Jeez, I'm taking
fire.
Oh
man. Kenshi video game. What is this? Real-time strategy action role-playing game developed and published by Lo-Fi Games for Windows. Huh. I have never heard of that. When did it come out? Not a JRPG. Post-apocalyptic. Be a traitor, a thief, a rebel, a warlord, an adventurer, a farmer, a slave, or just food for cannibals. When did it come out, David? See, man, we are like in a golden age of gaming because games just keep it coming out and I have no idea they exist. I didn't know this game existed till 5 days ago, so. Dude, you're gonna have to like get up here and get this guy. Okay, let's move.
Move
right there. Do you think maybe you can kill him now? Shoot him with your pistol.
Roger! Ready?
No, you missed it, broke him. You total Gomer. Oh my gosh.
I will take that.
Yeah, you will. Okay, in that case, we're gonna have to do this, boys. Mr. Heavy, can you? Yeah, you can at least give him a shot.
Take a bomb. Ooh,
yeah. The artwork. For Kenshi, the main artwork looks very interesting. The main logo page. I will be going and checking it out. 2018, the game came out. Well, see, that's one of my favorite games came out in 2017. Assassin's Creed Origins, man. That game looks like it came out yesterday. I love that game so much. Okay, so this is 9, and then you can overwatch
moving
these guys.
I have a target.
David says, I can't believe I only just found out about Barony. In Kenshi, you can crawl across the desert until you find a town where you can buy legs if you don't get captured by slavers first. That sounds cool. Cannot be stealth killed. An officer heals enemy morale and can be revived. Oh, well. I want to tell him, revive this. I will get many guys here in my cone of despair fire here.
Sure.
Let's do it. Yeah,
he's
baby.
He's a write-off. I'll sit down and think at an hospital.
Uh-oh, I'm flanked now. It's bad.
Fire.
Oh, no. No, no, no.
Augen offen halten.
Ich kämpfe weiter.
God's got a plan for me. This ain't how I die.
Okay, but I need you to get rid of this guy.
Chew on that.
Knife him.
He's full of lead. Snipe.
Oh, holy hell. Oh, he was one of those blow-up guys. Oh, no. That was no good. Oh, jeez. Okay, I'm learning a lot about this game as I play it. This is amazing.
I'm low on ammo.
You're high on needing to get the hell out of there, too. Okay, let's do this. Wait a minute, we got how many points? 8? 5 and 3.
Reloading!
I got grenades, and they're just for these types of occasions.
Bye-bye.
It's not gonna kill him. Yeah, take that, you sucker. Alright, what do we have over here? How far can we get over here? 9? 9, 9, 9, 9, 9. Get over here. Hackmanic says, remember the days when you had to wait for a good game to come out? Now it's like every 10 day, every day 10 games are released. You hardly get a chance to enjoy a game without feeling the rush to keep up. I know, that's the thing. That's why, like, there have been so many good games this year in the last 6 months. And Lamplighter League is an exact example of it. Of a game that I would really, really like to spend some time playing, but so many games keep coming out that I don't have a chance to get through it. Like, Last Epoch was not on my radar. And then it launches a couple of weeks ago, and I'm like, you know what? This looks really interesting. I'm going to try this. And I haven't been able to stop playing it. So, we are in a hell of an age.
Vérifiez votre secteur.
We are in one hell of an age right now. Okay. You need 3. Can you get over there? There, there. No. Can you get over here? Okay, here's what we're gonna do with you. We're gonna go like this.
Sie dürfen uns nicht besiegen. That just missed me.
Ah, yeah. David says that's why watch you play the games that we don't have time for.
Peace.
Oh no, no, no. Oh, he's recovering. You gotta hurry, buddy. Okay. You just need to move.
Move it!
I got guys getting hit.
Mag's almost empty.
Yeah, I know. I need you to kill this guy, can you?
I'm low on ammo. At your service.
You're 90% to hit him there. But
g'day.
What about you? What do you got? You got the big machine gun. 55% chance. He's 1 AP to revive. How do I want to play this? I gotta get him up. If you move 7 there, the best thing you can do is throw a grenade at that guy.
Wait!
And that's 4, and that'll give you a 90% chance to hit that guy. Okay.
Attack! 9, 9, 9, 9!
He He's suppressed, but that's not the end of the story. Now, can you knife him? Yes. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to go. It's 7 to revive and then 1 to knife a guy.
Move it! The guy from meine Flanke an.
Okay.
Thanks. You're a peach.
Yeah. It's going to be real peachy here.
You're not going home, mate.
Oh! He's out, Ed.
All right.
That's a humdinger.
A humdinger. So you're there, and what do you want to do with this guy? You can probably make him not move.
Can confirm. He suffered us. He's in my sights.
Yeah, he's broken, so he's going to lose his turn. His morale's broken. Officer that he is.
Can I help?
Maybe. That'll get you up there. It's 3.
Mm. What's the plan? I'm low on ammo.
Yeah, but you got enough. Can you finish him off?
Move
Go
in.
Get him then.
Have this. Ich bin verletzt. Morgen in Sunny.
Enemy down. He can be recovered. But we don't care about that.
Mag's almost empty.
I need you to get the hell out of there, bud.
Moving out!
You're reloaded fully, which is great.
En mouvement! You want me?
Yeah, I want you somewhere safe. What do you got left? 11 points?
Moving!
Is this a heal kit over here? No? Yes, no? Apparently not. Okay, two. Uh-oh, reinforcements coming.
I'm full of piss and vinegar.
Move it!
Okay.
What do you need?
Mag's almost empty.
I need you to get out of here. Because they're coming.
Move it!
They're one turn away.
All mouvement.
Can you take a shot at him? What does this do? It says he's recovering.
Bon voyage.
Kill confirmed.
That's a clapper.
Okay, so while he's recovering, he can be killed. Okay, that's what
Moving
I needed
out.
To know. That was the part I wanted. Everybody's used up points. Loser's coming.
You sons of bitches can't keep me down.
Moving
okay,
out.
Get in there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Moving.
Get
I'm
in
low
there.
On ammo.
You
Moving.
Don't have to worry about it, buddy, because
I'm low on ammo.
We're about to get out of here. Let's go. That's cool. Awesome. Wounds sustained. Decisive victory. Killed enemies without being detected. We missed that one. Extract quickly. That's awesome. This is good. Trousers. Oh my gosh, yeah, we've got some clothing and stuff. I need to go through weapons and things like that. This is wildly good. Oh, I love it. More skill points. Yeah, it's gonna be fantastic. So what I'm gonna do, like I think it was Hack that said it or Scott.
The Felgian Domery. They are the Wehrmacht's front line against the resistance. To become a military policeman, you need a certain kind of hombre. They recruited veterans, hard men with a streak of cruelty a mile wide. They'd cut their teeth fighting Ruski partisans out east. We were now in their sights, being hunted. Wherever the Felgian Domery were, our fights would be that bit tougher, that bit nastier.
Yeah, so what I'm going to do is I think I'll probably run through a playthrough of this and then do one for the channel once I've got full control of the game. But this is great. I love it already. I already love it. So everybody, I'm going to do fill 3 segments of this part. Hit and run. Okay. Interesting. What's this one? Hospital. The time for cure injuries task is reduced to 2 days. Oh. That might be cool. And this one is what? Enemy movement time is increased by 1 day. Okay. Cool. Well, I'm going to spend time figuring this game out, but for now I got to go do some stuff. Pirate radio. New mission is available. There's now it's opening up. We're getting a ton of stuff. Oh, occupying forces retaliate. Oh, fun. Moving 3 days. Oh, geez. Oh, my gosh. So now you got occupying forces moving around. Oh, geez. Operation Bolero. American troops squeeze into tent cities in southern England, preparing for the coming invasion. In addition, millions of tons of supplies pile up in depots across the country, ready to be shipped to ports for loading. Some transport ships from America sit in the harbor, awaiting the day they will be ordered directly to the invasion beaches. Can you imagine the logistics that it took to move that many people and that much equipment for D-Day? It's phenomenal. Okay, they're hunting me. Their presence in the region increases the enemy level and, oh, this thing up here, and the day cost of missions there. They can also launch reprisals against strong regions. Jeez, there's so much to this game. I think it's just going to get deeper and deeper the further it goes along, which is cool. It seems like they're really metering out everything at a really good pace. So I'm digging it. Yep. I got to go do some stuff. I got to go do food, laundry, all that jazz. I'll be back. Zoria, Age of the Shattering later tonight. And then probably some more Last Epoch really late at night. I'm just going to... It's just a full streaming day. So, folks, thanks for hanging around. Thanks for being here. If you dig it, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, leave questions and comments down below, and everyone, let me know that you want to see this as a series and it'll happen. Thanks. I'll see you all next time. Happy gaming, everyone.